Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University, where the 2-5 SMSU Mustangs will be taking on the Wayne State College Wildcats, who are 4-3. So, Paul, we welcome Paul Vold, our color commentator for the game. I am your play-by-play guy, Matt Callahan. And today, Paul, we got both teams coming off tough losses. So why don't you give us your three keys to the game here today?
Well, it starts here with the SMSU offense to limit the turnovers that they create. Charlie Kern throwing four interceptions last week at the University of Sioux Falls. So that's going to be a real key for them to limit shooting themselves in the foot, honestly. And to move on to the defense, SMSU defense really needs to limit the offense of Wayne State College, with Zach Osborne being the main target, who is leading the NSIC in passing and total offense. So look out for Zach Osborne, the quarterback. And also creating pressure for Wayne State College. He's only given up two sacks the entire season thus far throughout. And SMSU has seven sacks total. So creating pressure with players such as A.J. Page, Lance Boozer, Leon Perry, and the Werner brothers themselves. So that's really be the keys of the game for SMSU.
All righty. And today is senior night. So just a couple minutes before the game here, 12 seniors were honored with their family members at this time. And the players that were honored were Nathan Carr, Jordan Cross, Charlie Kern, Jacob Lefso, Cody McCleave, Adam Olson, Leon Perry, Daryl Thomas, Tyler Tondrum, Mike Wenk, Nathan Werner, and Mike Williams. So we look at this, and a victory for the Mustangs would be the first three-game winning streak over Wayne State College, and SMSU would improve to 3-1 on the season. So anyway, that's it for our pregame here. So we're going to take a two-minute break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU-TV.
We all have a vision of that perfect smile. But when it comes to our smile, it's not something we can draw or wait to miraculously appear. We need an orthodontist. Dental specialists with 2 to 3 years of specialized education beyond dental school. Your child might be the next Picasso, so trust that brilliant smile to the right hands. Seeing an orthodontist no later than age 7 can help achieve a healthy, beautiful smile. For more information, visit braces.org.
Southwest Minnesota State will get you where you want to go. We're a university of 3,600 students with over 45 majors to choose from. Small student-to-faculty ratios let your professors get to know you. And with a grad placement rate over 95%, your degree will help you get a job in your chosen field. Becoming involved is easy. And with over $150 million in improvements the last 10 years, our facilities are state-of-the-art. Southwest Minnesota State University, where you belong.
Southwest Minnesota State University, where private school atmosphere meets public school cost. Programs like culinology, agronomy, and environmental science set the standard nationwide, where grad placement rates are over 97%. And the school invests in you, putting over $80 million back into the university. Southwest Minnesota State University, where you belong.
Abuse or neglect, learn what you can do at BeHumane.org.
AmeriCorps Hero.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. We're just getting set for kickoff between the SMSU Mustangs and the Wayne State College Wildcats. So we just had our pregame show, and Paul, you were mentioning about some key players that are hurt during this game. Jacob Lefso has been lost for this season with an injury, and now Kevin Parks won't be playing in this game. So again, we're on the defensive side. Let's start out with Jacob Lefso. So he had a big sack against Upper Iowa to win the game. So against Lance Boozer gets the start. How do you think he's going to do in this game?
Yeah, I think what we've seen from Lance in the spot starts he's come into the season, he's definitely taken an advantage. So with Lance being in the lineup to start the game, I feel like he is going to have a monster game today.
We got Tyler Tonnerum and Andrew McReynolds back to receive the kickoff. And Wayne State coming off a very tough loss to Augustana, losing 52-48 last week at home. And here comes the kick. Up, and it'll go to Tyler Tonnerum. Looks like he'll return it at about the one. Tonnerum's got some blocking, but he'll be tackled at about the 18-yard line. So here comes the SMSU offense. Had a rough going against Sioux Falls last week, losing 44-20. So, Paul, what are you looking for the offense to do here on this first drive?
I'm looking at what Charlie Kern does to start the game, coming off that loss at the hands of Sioux Falls, 44-20, as we had mentioned. Charlie Kern throwing four interceptions in that game. Seeing what he can do with the ball to not cause any mistakes.
We have trips to the left. We got Jordan Cross, Adam Olson, and Nathan Carr. Screen pass to Jordan Cross. Nice little gain there for Cross, one of the Flow brothers, as Paul likes to call him. He'll be down at about 26-yard line of the Mustangs.
See, that's what I'm going to be looking for as well, those quick wide receiver screens to Charlie Kern's left right there. Always a go-to for him. Go for another one.
Pretty much the same play there for the Mustangs, and it'll get them the first down. If it works the first time, might as well go do it a second time, huh, Paul?
It's just like the old saying, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
There you go. Tyler Tonnerum with Charlie Kern in shotgun. Kern takes the snap. Play it. Oh, no, he'll hand it off to Tyler Tonnerum. Nice run for Tyler Tonnerum. And, Paul, we've seen Tyler Tonnerum not do the best in the beginning of the game, but sometimes in later in the game he'll bust out a long run or catch a nice pass. So what does Tyler Tonnerum really have to do here in this early going?
You know, he's just really got to get his touches is the thing. You know, he's been limited at times when he does not get the ball. But when Tyler Tonnerum does, he makes the most of it. I mean, it's to start out the game, you know, he's not busting out those big 50-yard gainers. But when you get like a 3-4-yard game, it really sets up a big 40-50-yard run.
Nice pass by Charlie Kern there. 15-yard completion to Nate Carr. And that'll give the Mustangs another first down. It'll be handoff to Tyler Tonnerum. And we'll go up the middle. It'll be tackled. It'll be in about the 44-yard line. So Tyler Tonnerum, his second carry of the game.
It's Tommy Steidler checks into the game. Carr comes out. Probably something with his helmet.
We've seen, you know, a couple of high snaps for the Mustangs here. That was a nice one right there, and Tyler Tonnerum takes the carry, and he'll get the first down. Nice running by Tyler Tonnerum. Nice blocking by the offensive line so far.
Yeah, I don't know if the high snap thing is a preference of Charlie Kearns, but so far it hasn't affected him too much. We've seen that a lot this season. Go a little hurry up here.
Wildcats changing the defense. Looks like they're going blitz. They'll do another screen pass, and this won't work. Incomplete. And Jordan Cross has been targeted three times, but he has two receptions for 14 yards already on the game. Nate Carr, one reception, 15 yards. Charlie Kern, three completions, four attempts, 29 yards. So pretty good start here for the Mustangs so far.
Yeah, they're moving the ball at the pace that they always do. With those quick wide receiver screens, Charlie Kern, and a designed run here.
Another quarterback draw for Kern. And it looks like he may have fumbled the ball, but it looks like he will be down. About 1 yard gain for Charlie Kern there.
He was a little slow to get up. Seems to be limping a little bit, Charlie Kern.
we got Cross and Olsen to the right, and looks like offsides or false start. I don't know. It looks like Mustangs are saying it's on the Wildcats. Referees are debating. And we'll get the official call here soon. The encroachment on the Wildcats, their first penalty of the game. And that will give the Mustangs about a third and four now. And Charlie Kern in the shotgun. Tyler Tonnerum to the right of him. Switching the play up here. Looks like the Wildcats are shaking up their defense. They're going 3-4, and now they only have one down lineman. Another screen to Nathaniel Hewitt, and looks like he will get the first down a little more. Or he did step out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. Good job by Nathaniel Hewitt to get the first down.
Nathaniel Hewitt there been a welcome addition to the team this past season. He's definitely one to break tackles after initial contact and fight for extra yards.
And like we saw in that Upper Iowa game, over 100 yards and a touchdown on a nice 66-yard reception. Kern trying to get the Wildcats offsides. And now Kern is going to audible here. Kern handoff Tyler Tonnerum. And he's got some room, and he'll be rolls over a Wildcat, and he's down at about the 3-yard line. Tyler Tonnerum
runs over number 38, John Davis, the defensive back there. And Davis was feeling that hit after Tonnerum just demolished him about at the 15-yard line.
Give it to Tonnerum again, but it looks like he'll be stuffed at about the 2-yard line. And there we go, Tyler Tonnerum has about 4 carries on the game. Had a nice run there. Ran over a couple Wildcats. And the Mustangs are, looks like an illegal substitution on the field on the Wildcats, so that'll move the Mustangs up a little bit more. Second penalty of the game. So the Mustangs looking like they're going to capitalize here.
And this is where SMSU is most deadliest, when they're in tight here on the goal line, because you don't know what play they're going to go with. Are they going to give it to Tonnerum like they will do on this play?
And off to Tonnerum, and he will go untouched into the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs. They take a 6-0 lead. So, Paul, very nice drive for the Mustangs here.
Yeah, a very smart drive there from the Mustangs. Charlie Kern made right decisions with the ball, getting it to his receivers. 4 completions on that drive. And when he had to run the ball, he ran with it and gave it to Tyler Tonnerum.
Here's one of the best kickers in the SIC, Mike Wank, for the extra point, and it is up, and it is good. The Mustangs take a 7-0 lead over the Wayne State College Wildcats. We'll take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang football here on KSSU TV.
We all have a vision of that perfect smile, but when it comes to our smile, it's not something we can draw or wait to miraculously appear. We need an orthodontist. Dental specialists with 2 to 3 years of specialized education beyond dental school. Your child might be the next Picasso, so trust that brilliant smile to the right hands. Seeing an orthodontist no later than age 7 can help achieve a healthy, beautiful smile. For more information, visit braces.org.
Southwest Minnesota State will get you where you want to go. We're a university of 3,600 students with over 45 majors to choose from. Small student to faculty ratios let your professors get to know you. And with a grad placement rate over 95%, your degree will help you get a job in your chosen field. Becoming involved is easy. And with over $150 million in improvements the last 10 years, our facilities are state of the art. Southwest Minnesota State University, where you belong.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. And the Wildcats will take the kickoff. And he's got some blocking, number 11 for the Wayne State Wildcats. Lane Yates on on the run there, 5'8", 185, freshman from Omaha, Nebraska, on the nice return. And here comes the Wildcat offense. Paul, you mentioned about Zach Osborne, one of the best quarterbacks here in the NSIC, leader in passing yards. So what do the Mustangs really have to do to keep him in check?
They really have to keep him inside the pocket is what they really need to do, not allow him to get outside of the pocket and create something down the field with his receivers. So they really need to keep him contained, get lots of pressure on him.
And Osborne, two wide receivers to his left. Osborne, handoff to Yates. It'll be a small gain for the Wildcats right there.
Met right away there by number 44, Alex Burton.
Alex Burton, one of the leading tacklers for the Mustangs. And here come the Wildcats in the pistol formation. Yates in the backfield. And Osborne will go back to pass. He's looking deep. He's got his wide receiver. Number 19, Cole McDaniel, senior out of Tracy, California, on the catch. And the Wildcats have a three wide set. Pistol formation again, Yates in the backfield. Mustang showing blitz, and they'll go deep to his guy, number 14, and a nice catch by number 14, Brian Kent. Wide receiver from junior from Wakanda, Illinois. He tackled it about the 9-yard line, and Zach Osborne looking pretty sharp here, Paul, so far.
So far, he has not disappointed. Jared Tweed on the coverage there on number 14, Brian Kent there. Did not see the ball, didn't turn around there. Brian Kent was able to make a fabulous catch there.
Number 44, Alex Burton showing blitz. Right there, Osborne had to change the play. Osborne will go back to pass again. He's looking for McDaniel, and he's got it! And a touchdown for the Wildcats. What a catch by McDaniel there. Nice fade route, and he went up and got it. And to be honest, Cole McDaniel, 6'4", wide receiver. I mean, it's kind of tough. I mean, this guy's got some talent, Paul.
Yeah, the way that Osborne threw that ball, he's been throwing it high to his receivers where only they can go get it, and that's definitely worked in their favor so far.
And on the extra point for the Wildcats will be Tyree Bethea, Tyler Lindsay, and his snap is up, the kick is up, and it's good, and the Wildcats strike back. So here we go, Mustangs are tied 7-7 here at Mackey Field. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
We all have a vision of that perfect smile, but when it comes to our smile, it's not something we can draw or wait to miraculously appear. We need an orthodontist. Dental specialists with 2 to 3 years of specialized education beyond dental school. Your child might be the next Picasso, so trust that brilliant smile to the right hands. Seeing an orthodontist no later than age 7 can help achieve a healthy, beautiful smile. For more information, visit braces.org.
Southwest.
And welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. And again, you look at the Wayne State Wildcats go on a nice drive, 4 plays, 47 yards, 1 minute and 23 seconds taken off the clock. And just looking at some of the stats here, Paul, I mean, you got to look at Zach Osborne, 3 of 3, 47 yards and a touchdown. I mean, he was on fire that drive.
Yeah, especially when you get a good return from your running back, Lane Yates there, 50-yard return to help set up the short field and just made it easy for Osborne to score.
Lindsay will kick it off and will roll to Andrew McReynolds. He'll take it at about the 9. And he's got some blocking. And he will be breaking some tackles. And he'll be tackled at about the 35-yard line finally. Mustangs are calling for a flag on the play, a late hit out of bounds.
Looked like it would have been a late hit out of bounds with that. I believe that Wayne State player coming at the end, but no flag there. Good return there from Andrew McReynolds. Had a couple stiff arms to fight for some extra yards there.
And here we go, Tyler Tondrum. Last drive, 5 attempts, 40 yards and a touchdown. Like we said, Paul, I mean, we needed him to get going early. And he has 5 attempts, 40 yards, and he'll take the carry again. And he'll run over a Wildcat, but then he'll be tackled at about the 32-yard line of the Mustangs. And we got 3 wide receivers to the right. Tommy Steidler, Adam Olson, Nathaniel Hewitt, and Jordan Cross on the left. Kern's rolling out, and he'll find Nathaniel Hewitt. And he'll be down at about the 45-yard line, and that'll be a first down for the Mustangs. Those short passes are working pretty good here, Paul.
Yeah, Charlie Kern looking very confident early in this matchup, getting the ball out of his hand to his receivers that let them work a little bit, especially with Nathaniel Hewitt, who I feel like they've been working together very well throughout the whole season.
Looks like they have some cohesiveness between all his receivers, Charlie Kern, Adam Olson. We got Jordan Cross as well, Nathaniel Hewitt, and a nice run by Tyler Tondrum down at about the 49-yard line of the Mustangs. And just looking at some of the receiving stats, Jordan Cross, 2 receptions, 14 yards, and Nathaniel Hewitt, 2 receptions, 12 yards, and Nate Carr, 1 reception for 15 yards. Kern and shotgun will take the snap. Looking short to Adam Olson. And he'll get a short gain on that one, down at about the 49-yard line of the Wildcats.
Number 16 there, Nathan Scott was all over Olson on that one to not allow him to get any extra yards after the catch.
Charlie Kern now, 6 completions, 7 attempts, 45 yards. Going to change the play again here. Charlie Kern changes the play. And the Wildcats look like they're showing blitz, and they will. Kern's going to roll out, and he's going to find Olson, and he'll get the first down. And he'll be down at about the 41-yard line.
Very nice blitz pickup there by Charlie Kern to roll to his right and find Adam Olson for the first down.
Adam Olson, his second reception of the game, 2 for 9 yards. Kern's going to hand it off to Tyler Tonnerum. He's got some blocking, but he'll be tackled at about the 38-yard line. It's Tyler Tonnerum. His 8th attempt on the game, and that should push him over 50 yards. A great start by Tyler Tonnerum, like we said, and a lot of nice short passing so far.
Haven't seen too much of Devontae Stevens or Ashanti Payne going with Tyler Tondrum here to start the game, and it's worked out so far for them.
And a nice play right there by Tyson McGill, linebacker, senior from Norfolk, Nebraska, sniffing out that screen and tackling Jordan Cross for a loss. And 3rd and 9 for the Mustangs. They're 2 of 2 on third down so far in this game. And there's Devontae Stevens in the backfield. Trips to the right. Kern's going to look to Stevens, and he'll throw it incomplete. Looks like Kern and Stevens are trying to figure out what happened there.
Even if he did make the catch there, there were 3 Wildcats right in his area. He probably would not have made the first down there.
Here comes Mike Wink on to punt for the Mustangs. And the returner will be for the Wildcats, Tyree Bethea. And Wink on the punt. Nice high punt. And it will go into the end zone for a touchback. Too bad it didn't stop at the 1 and bounce back. So here comes the Wildcat offense. I mean, their drive, last drive fall. I mean, looking at Zach Osborne, 3 completions on 3 attempts, 47 yards and a touchdown. And looking at some of their receivers, Cole McDaniel, 6'4 receiver, 2 receptions, 24 yards and a touchdown. Brian Kent, 1 reception, 23 yards. So the Mustang defense didn't want the start they really wanted to get there. So, Paul, what do you think they have to do now on this drive?
You know, they really have to play better man-to-man or the defensive backs themselves, a little bit of a mismatch going up against these taller wide receivers of Wayne State, so you're really going to have to jam them at the line to not allow them to get a great release.
And Osborne will hand it off to Yates, Lane Yates, and he'll get a couple of yards there. Looking at some of the rushing stats for Wayne State, the rushing yardage, they average 154.6 yards per game. And another handoff to Yates, and he'll have some nice yards there in the first down, but there is a flag on the play. It looks like maybe holding on Wayne State. And the referees for this evening, Rolf Erickson, referee out of Plymouth, Minnesota, John Caldwell, umpire, and Anthony Dewar, linesman judge. And then you got Jeffrey Johnson from Andover, Minnesota, Robert Norman from Brooklyn Center, Minnesota, and Jerry Teague's Maple Grove, Minnesota, and Jared Butson, St. Charles, Minnesota. So that'll be the second penalty on the Wayne State Wildcats. Oh, third penalty, excuse me. The Wildcats. It'll be a second and long for the Wildcats. And the Mustangs showing blitz, and they will. And Osborne rolls out to the left, and he's looking for his guy McDaniel, and he almost had it, but looks like it'll be pass interference on Andrew McReynolds. Hit him a little early there.
Yeah, McReynolds went low there on McDaniel. Hit him in the back of the knee, and it could be construed as pass interference.
Looks like McReynolds just went a little too early on there. He thought the ball was caught by McDaniel at first. It'll be an automatic first down for the Wildcats. The first penalty on the Mustangs. The Mustangs are probably one of the least penalized teams in the NSIC so far. So again, here comes Osborne out of the pistol formation again. Looks like we're going to be seeing that a lot tonight. Osborne, short pass to Yates, and he'll take it to about the 37-yard line of the Wildcats. And Zach Osborne still perfect with completions, 4 of 4, 50 yards and a touchdown.
Lane Yates, the running back, true freshman, as we heard in the booth here, getting a lot of touches tonight early, whether it be out of the backfield or rushing, and especially on special teams too, so he's definitely getting his looks on the offense.
Osborne back to pass, he's looking deep. He's got his wide receiver, number 4, and he will drop it. Adam Stark, number 4, senior from Elkhorn, Nebraska, had a chance to get some big yardage there. It looks like he couldn't hold on to that one, Paul.
Jared Tweed had a chance to pick that one up as well. Just off the fingertips of Adam Stark.
It'll be third down for the Wildcats. Haven't attempted a third down yet in this game. Here comes Osborne again, and he's going to look deep for McDaniel, and he will catch it. And he will get the first down. He is down at about the 45-yard line of the Wildcats. Cole McDaniel, his third reception on the game. I mean, this guy is 6'4", Paul. I mean, you got to try and press him at the line as best you can.
Yeah, with the way our smaller defensive backs are, it's definitely a mismatch against McDaniel. So pressing him at the line will be a key.
Another pistol formation for Wildcats. And Osborne back to pass, looking for his tight end. That'll be knocked down. Second down for the Wildcats. Number 89, Joe Truba, senior from Omaha, Nebraska, was the intended receiver on that play.
Osborne has not looked too shaky in the pocket. He's looked very confident with pressure coming at him, throwing perfect balls to his receivers.
5 completions on 7 attempts. 61 yards and a touchdown for Osborne so far. And he'll roll out. Looks like an option play, and he is hit immediately at about the 45-yard line. Good job by the Mustangs. Looks like Lance Boozer was there on the tackle. It'll be 3rd and 9 for the Wildcats. 1 of 1 on 3rd down so far. Looks like the Wildcats are trying to call out a play. Looks like the fans are really getting into it so far here, Paul.
Especially with the defense that's been playing so far in this game, keeping them in the game against this offense definitely gets the fans excited.
Here comes Osborne, takes a snap, blitz coming, and it looks like it'll be broken up by Andrew McReynolds. Great job by Andrew McReynolds to break up that pass.
Right there with the receiver the whole time, and was able to get a hand on it and not allow the receiver to catch it. Good play there by McReynolds.
McReynolds will take the punt here. And Mustangs stop him on a 3rd down. And the Mustang defense coming back on this drive to make a stop after it looked pretty, for the Wildcats, at least too easy. But the Mustang defense stands strong this drive. So here's the punt. McReynolds is going to go away from it. And it's going to bounce, and it'll stop at about the 1-yard line. So it'll pin the Mustang offense back to their own 1-yard line. Great job by the Wildcats on the punt coverage.
If it was easy for everybody would be doing it if this sport was easy. Being pinned, looks like it'll be placed at the 3-yard line now.
Yep.
So a little bit of breathing room, but not a whole lot. Still in the shadow of your own end zone. So it's going to be a real character drive here for the Mustangs.
Here comes the Mustang offense. Devontae Stevens in the backfield now.
Also seeing Ty Stephenson in the game for the first time.
And the Mustangs will go shotgun here. Trying to get the Wildcats offsides again. Charlie Kern going to change up the play. Kern will give it, or he will fake it to Stevens, and Kern breaks a tackle, and he'll get the first down, and he'll be tackled at the 15-yard line. Charlie Kern breaking a lot of tackles right there, Paul.
You know, had both of us fooled, as it looked like Devontae Stevens had the ball and was only going to lose yards on that one. A very nice play by Charlie Kern to get out. A little more breathing room now at the 15.
Kern's going to go short pass to Stephenson, and he'll catch it. Bounce off his blocker, and he'll be tackled at about this 17-yard line. And Ty Stephenson, his first reception on the game. That'll be the 5th receiver Charlie Kern has gone to in this game. Wildcats showing blitz. Kern going to change up the play.
That's what Charlie Kern does best. He gets everyone involved in the offense, not singling out one player so that the defense can take advantage of that one particular player.
Nice handoff to Devontae Stevens, and he'll be tackled at about the 20-yard line of the Mustangs. 3rd down for the Mustangs. 2 of 3 on 3rd down so far in this game, 66%. We got trips to the right for the Mustangs. Kern, blitz coming from the Wildcats, throwing it up to Jordan Cross, and he'll catch it, but he'll be out of bounds. Nice play by number 5 for the Wildcats, Jerron Irby, 6'190" senior from Hercules, California. And here comes Mike Wank on the punt. The Mustangs get stopped on that drive there, Paul. So looks like Wildcats kind of had their number that drive.
Yeah, it wasn't exactly the best drive in the world, but definitely some good notes out of that drive.
Number 6 with a nice breaking a lot of tackles, and there's flag on the play. Tyree Bethea on the return. Had some shifty moves there. And we'll get the official call coming up here soon by head referee Rolf Erickson. That'll be their fourth penalty on the game, the Wildcats. Last drive, the Wildcats had to punt. They're back here out on the field. Looking at some of the stats here, Paul, for the Wildcats. Lane Yates, 3 attempts, 6 yards. Zach Osborne, 1 attempt, 1 yard. But receiving-wise, they've been pretty efficient. Cole McDaniel, 3 receptions, 35 yards, and a touchdown. Brian Kent, 1 reception, 23 yards, and Lane Yates, 1 reception. Brian Kent, 1 reception, 23 yards, and then Lane Yates, 1 reception, 3 yards. So, this Wayne State team is a passing team, and they're being quite efficient here, Paul.
They're definitely seeing a lot more run than I would expect from this offense, but their defense is limiting the big play passing-wise.
Lane Yates with a nice run there to get the first down. Andrew McReynolds looked like he had a tackle for only like a couple of yards, but he looks like he just kind of threw his shoulder out there instead of wrapping up. And Osborne will hand it off to Yates, and he'll be tackled about the 50-yard line. Lane Yates is his fifth carry on the game. Gain of 7, and it'll be 2nd and 2. 5 attempts, 25 yards for Lane Yates.
Yates, a smaller running back. He's definitely very shifty out of the backfield, making a couple players miss.
A nice catch and throw. Zach Osborne put it right on the money to number 14, Brian Kent. His 2nd reception on the game. Nice gain there.
Very nice chip block there from Yates on Burton, and I believe number 4 for Southwest, Alex Oliver, to allow Osborne to throw the ball there.
He'll be overthrown by Osborne. He's looking for his guy, Cole McDaniel, on that play. Nice defense by the Mustangs right there. Seeing the Mustang defense show a lot of blitz here in this game, trying to get Osborne off his game, but it looks like he's pretty comfortable in the pocket so far, Paul.
Yeah, definitely not a lot of pressure coming from the defensive line of Southwest, but when they have gotten pressure, Osborne's gotten rid of the ball quick.
Yates will take the carry again, and he's breaking a lot of tackles, and he'll be finally tackled at about the 32-yard line, and that should end the first quarter here at Mackey Field at the Schwann Regional Event Center. Second quarter is coming up, so we're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
We all have a vision of that perfect smile, but when it comes to our smile, it's not something we can draw or wait to miraculously appear. We need an orthodontist. Dental specialists with 2 to 3 years of specialized education beyond dental school. Your child might be the next Picasso, so trust that brilliant smile to the right hands. Seeing an orthodontist no later than age 7 can help achieve a healthy, beautiful smile. For more information, visit braces.org.
Southwest Minnesota.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. Mustangs are tied with the Wayne State Wildcats 7-7. And, you know, a pretty good first half for the Mustangs so far, Paul. Offensively, pretty solid. Had to punt on the last drive, but so far, so good. Charlie Kern, 9 completions, 12 yards, 49 yards. Tyler Tondrum getting going early. 8 attempts, 49 yards, and a touchdown. And so, I mean, they got the running game going. Defensively, the Mustangs had a couple good stops after that first drive. So what are you looking for in the second quarter, Paul?
You know, I'm just seeing what they can build off from that first quarter, especially in that first series for the Mustangs, with how they just marched right down the field. And then after that, it's been kind of slow as both teams, you know, not really lighting up the field or the stat sheets.
Osborne, little to the outside of his reach for Cole McDaniel. Daniel tried to reel that in.
Fourth down here. Offense still on the field.
It'll be a fourth down, and Wildcats will be going for it.
Fourth and 10.
Here comes Osborne, their first fourth down attempt on the game. The Mustang showing blitz here. Back to pass is Osborne. He's got some pressure, and he's gonna run. Nice pass to Cole McDaniel, and they'll get the first down. A nice job by Cole McDaniel to get open on that play. Looks like Osborne was about to get sacked there.
Osborne stepping up in the pocket right there. Just at the last second, you think he was going to run, then he throws it to McDaniel.
And here comes Yates back into the game. And Osborne changing the play here for the Wildcats. Mustangs showing blitz. First down and 10 from the 16. And Osborne back to pass, looking for McDaniel again. And he'll get the catch there at about the 16-yard line of the Mustangs.
Very good matchup right there of McDaniel and McReynolds, I believe that is, over on the far side. A very interesting matchup right there. McDaniel's a very physical cornerback going up against a big receiver that is McDaniel.
Second and 8 for the Wildcats. Pistol formation. Mustangs changing up their defensive scheme. Yates he's got some speed coming from the corner. He'll break a couple tackles. He'll be down at about the 1 or 2 yard line, and he'll get the first down as well. Lane Yates, his 7th attempt on the game. That'll put him over 30 yards. First and goal for the Wildcats, trying to take a lead here. Hand off to Yates, and he'll be hit immediately. Nice tackle by number 44, Alex Burton, on the play. We've seen a lot of Alex Burton lately in this game, Paul.
Definitely, Alex Burton's been right at the line of scrimmage every time, whether he's collapsing a hole and meeting the running back right away, or that busting through the line and getting a loss on the play.
Looks like eye formation for the Wildcats. Osborne will pitch it over to Yates, and he tries to get the corner, and he'll dive for the end zone, and he will get it. Touchdown, Wildcats. And nice blocking from the Wildcat offensive line, and again, Lane Yates on the touchdown. Very shifty running back, ball.
Yeah, he definitely got some speed on his side. Lane Yates there was able to get to the corner, beat the defender there for the touchdown.
We got place kicker Tyler Lindsay on the extra point. And the Wildcats take a 13-7 lead pending the extra point. 12:44 left in the second quarter. Snap, the spot, and the kick is up, and the extra point is good. So the Wayne State College Wildcats take the lead over the SMSU Mustangs 14-7. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching KSSU TV.
We all have a vision of that perfect smile. But when it comes to our smile, it's not something we can draw or wait to miraculously appear. We need an orthodontist, dental specialists with 2 to 3 years of specialized education beyond dental school. Your child might be the next Picasso, so trust that brilliant smile to the right hands. Seeing an orthodontist no later than age 7 can help achieve a healthy, beautiful smile. For more information, visit braces.org.
Southwest Minnesota State will get you where you want to go. We're a university of 3,600 students with over 45 majors to choose from. Small student-to-faculty ratios let your professors get to know you. And with a grad placement rate over 95%, your degree will help you get a job in your chosen field. Becoming involved is easy. And with over $150 million in improvements the last 10 years, our facilities are state-of-the-art. Southwest Minnesota State University.
Welcome back to Mackey Field. There's the kickoff by the Wildcats. Looks like McReynolds will field the kick, and he's got some room to the sideline. Nice blocking by the Mustangs, and he'll be down at about the 36-yard line. I'm just kind of looking at going back to this drive here, Paul. Lane Yates, 4-yard run, and on that drive it was 11 plays, 60 yards. Took some time off the clock, and now they're up 14-7, Mustang offense. Looking to answer here, what are you looking for the Mustang offense to do on this second quarter drive?
You know, really look at what they did in that first drive when they marched right down to the field with a touchdown. Let's get the ball out quick, get it to the receivers on those screens there, and allow Tyler Tondrum to run with the ball as well. That's what I'm looking forward to. A lot smarter decisions from Charlie Kern.
Kern's going to throw an out route, and it looks like it was almost intercepted by a Wildcat there. Jerron Irby, senior out of Hercules, California, looks like he almost had the interception there. Nice jump on the ball by Irby.
Olsen wasn't ready for that ball right there. Wasn't even turned around to see where it was coming from.
And Kern back to pass. He's looking for cross again, and it looks like he is out of bounds. And looks like Mustangs, tough two plays there, almost intercepted, and Charlie Kern threw it a little bit outside to the sidelines. So, but Charlie Kern so far on the game, 9 completions, 14 attempts, 49 yards. Trips to the right for the Mustangs. Pass to Ty Stephenson, and he'll break a tackle and be down at about the 42-yard line of the Mustangs. And the Mustangs can't convert. They go three and out on that drive there. And a couple of plays that just didn't go really their way, Paul. And then here comes Mike Wank on the punt. And here comes Tyree Bethea on to receive the punt. Mike Wank. This one, nice kick by Wank.
Real high,
but it'll be a touchback for the Wildcats, and they'll start out from their own 20. The Wildcats on their last drive scored a touchdown. So, Paul, what are you looking for the Mustang defense to do here?
You know, being able to keep Zach Osborne in the pocket has not worked out well for the Mustangs. So what they really need to do is really work on those wide receivers a little bit more, because that's where Osborne's going to do his damage, is throwing the ball, even with Lane Yates in the backfield.
Look out for Cole McDaniel. 5 receptions, 53 yards, and a touchdown. 6'4 receiver. Has been Osborne's main target in this game.
Like Ludlow in the backfield for Wayne State.
Pistol formation again. Hand off to Ludlow. And he'll get a nice gain on that play down at about the 26-yard line. His first carry of the game. It'll be second and about 4 on the Wildcat 26-yard line. Ludlow in the backfield again, trips to the right for the Wildcats. Play action. Osborne's going to look deep for his man, Kent, and he's got it, and he'll get inside the 10-5 touchdown Wildcats. It looks like Brian Kent just turned on the afterburners and got by the Mustang secondary. Nice throw by Zach Osborne for that touchdown.
Kent there had a beat on the defender, cut back in towards the seam, and got the ball about the 40-yard line, and he did not look back on that one.
Nice throw by Zach Osborne. 74-yard touchdown play. And the Wayne State College Wildcats extend their lead 20-7, pending the extra point. And Lindsay on the kick. Kick is up. And it is good. So here we go. The Wildcats take a 21-7 lead. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Southwest Minnesota State University, where private school atmosphere meets public school cost. Programs like culinology, agronomy, and environmental science set the standard nationwide, where grad placement rates are over 97%. And the school invests in you, putting over $80 million back into the university. Southwest Minnesota State University, where you belong.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University. And the Wayne State College Wildcats take a 21-7 lead. So let's look at this drive here, Paul. Only two plays, 80 yards, and only took 41 seconds off the clock. Zach Osborne, 74-yard touchdown pass to Adam Stark. I mean, just kind of looking at it, Paul, I mean, the Mustangs just... Mustang defense, I mean, there's a lot of weapons for the Wildcats. They just couldn't defend them on that drive.
Yeah, too many choices for Zach Osborne to go with.
Here we go, McReynolds. And he'll break a couple tackles. And he's still on his feet. And he'll finally be taken down at about the 28-yard line of the Mustangs. So here comes the Mustang offense. Went 3-and-out on their last drive. And Charlie Curran didn't seem to be himself on that drive. A couple of overthrows and short pass play, and then an overthrow to Jordan Cross. So what do you think Charlie Curran has to do here on this drive?
You know, he just has to go back to his bread and butter, give Tyler Tondrum the football, and hit those quick bubble screens that have been so effective for SMSU all season.
It'll be a handoff to Tyler Tondrum, and he'll break a tackle and be finally tackled at about the 36-yard line of the Mustangs. Second down, Tyler Tondrum, his ninth carry of the game, and he'll get another carry as well, and he'll break another tackle, but he'll trip at about the 39-yard line. Boy, if he didn't trip there, it looked like he could have gotten more yards.
Yeah, the turf monster there strikes again, this time not in SMSU's favor.
It'll be 3rd-and-1 for the Mustangs. Curran in the shotgun. Devontae Stevens will take the carry. And he'll break a couple tackles, and he's got the sideline. He'll stiff arm Irby, and he'll be knocked out of bounds at about the 47-yard line of the Wildcats. Devontae Stevens, his second carry of the game. He's got 23 yards, a nice 20-yard gain on that play. Tyler Tondrum back in the game. Another handoff to Tondrum, and he'll be hit immediately by a bunch of Wildcats at about the 44-yard line.
Seems that SMSU is going a bit little more hurry up on this one compared to the early drives where they've been just kind of relaxed, get the play in and all that. Now they're just going up-tempo here.
They've been effective with that up-tempo offense. Kern's going to do a quarterback run here, and he'll slide at about the 31-yard line. It'll be about third down for the Mustangs. They have been 3 of 6 on third down so far in this game, 3rd-and-5 coming up here. Devontae Stevens back in the game. Kern will take the snap. And Kern's in some trouble. He's got to find his receiver. And Stevens will get the catch, but he will be stuffed or hit for lost almost at about the 36-yard line of the Wildcats.
It looks like they're going to stay on the field here for fourth down and five.
And it looks like a timeout for the Wildcats. It looks like an injury on the play. So anyway, we're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Ladies, are you talking to your partners
about HIV?
Two out of every three new HIV/AIDS cases in women are among black women.
Get informed. Get tested. Early detection can save your life. If you test positive, seek treatment from a doctor.
Join the campaign to end black AIDS, a partnership between Abbott and the Magic Johnson Foundation. Go to WeStandWithMagic.com, get resources, and become a member.
And join today, and thank you.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. The injured Wildcat on that was Tyree Bathia. Got off under his own power, so that's good to see. And it'll be false start, it looks like, on the Mustangs. But the Mustangs are saying maybe it's encroachment on the Wildcats. Looks like they're debating right here.
Could go either way on this call. Could be encroachment from the defensive player making the lineman move on that one, or it could just be a old-fashioned false start.
Looks like both teams pretty much are saying that
they're stating their case.
Yep. They're still debating on who it was. Looks like it will be on the Wildcats. And that'll move the Mustangs up to about the 32-yard line. Be a first down for the Mustangs
on the encroachment there. So definitely what the Mustangs need right there, a way to get a first down and hopefully spark this offense.
And here we go, the Mustang offense back out, hand off to Tyler Tondrum. He'll run up to about a 1 yard gain for the Mustangs. Be down at about, or excuse me, 2 yard gain. Be down at about the 30-yard line. Tyler Tondrum on the game. 11 attempts, 57 yards and a touchdown. Excuse me, 12 attempts now, 59 yards and a touchdown. Kern rolls out, throws it to Nathaniel Hewitt. And a nice catch on that play down at about the 21-yard line. Nathaniel Hewitt, his third reception on the game. Been kind of quiet lately so far in this game, but Charlie Kern has thrown to at least six different receivers in this game, so he's spreading the wealth here, Paul.
Definitely getting everyone involved, as I had mentioned earlier, not allowing one player to get all the attention from the defense, thus creating more options for him in the pass game.
Charlie Kern trying to look deep, and he's going to throw it away. Looks like there was some pressure there from the Wildcats, number 32, Zach Bierman, 6'4", 195 junior from Battle Creek, Nebraska, on the pressure. 7:25 left in the second quarter. Nate Carr will go out, trips right, with both of the Flo brothers, Adam Olson and Jordan Cross. A nice quick pass to Nathan Carr, and he'll be tackled at about the 15. Nate Carr, his second reception of the game. One of the seniors that was honored tonight here for the Mustangs. 12 seniors were honored prior to today's game. Good to see Nate Carr and his family. Charlie Kern, hand off to Tyler Tondrum, and he's got some running room, and he'll get the first down, and he's still on his feet, but they'll mark him down at about the 7-yard line. So this drive looks pretty good here, Paul. What do you think the Mustangs have to do to get this touchdown?
You know, they really just got to keep going with what they got. Tyler Tondrum has been running with the ball very effectively. We have a thoroughbred on this team. You do not lock him in the barn. You get him on the field, and you let him run.
Curran back to pass. He's looking to Nathaniel Hewitt. Nice short out, and he'll break a tackle and dive for the end zone. Touchdown, Nathaniel Hewitt. His first of the game. Nice pass by Charlie Curran. And, well, there's a lot of more weapons as well with your wide receivers. If you can lock up Tondrum, well, you got Nathaniel Hewitt, Jordan Cross, and Nathaniel Hewitt. Nice crossing route, nice catch, nice touchdown.
Not only did that touchdown make Coach Sauter happy, made Coach Bigler very happy on that one, seeing him clap down towards the end zone over by the gate. Coach Bigler very happy with the way one of his players.
And the extra point is up. And the Mustangs still down a touchdown in this game, 21-14, the Wildcats lead. But we're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU Television. Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. The Mustangs go on a 12-play, 71-yard drive. Took 4 minutes and 16 seconds off the clock. And it is 21-14 Wildcats. Charlie Curran, 7-yard touchdown pass to Nathaniel Hewitt. And Paul, you got to like that drive right there. And the Mustang defense give up a touchdown, but the Mustang offense answers back.
Very reminiscent of the first drive of the game, giving Tondrum the ball a number of times and those quick screens out to the receivers as well.
Here comes Yates again. He's been doing a great job in the special teams department, getting up to the 40-yard line on the Wildcats.
Him and Andrew McReynolds for SMSU have been setting up both offenses, allowing them a shorter field, thus creating more issues on defense.
Here comes the Wildcat offense again. Looking at Zach Osborne, I mean, he's been terrific so far. 9 completions, 14 attempts, 171 yards, and 2 touchdowns. 1 to Cole McDaniel, and 1 to Adam Stark. And Osborne's going to look deep again, and he's looking for Stark, but he'll be hit by, was it Jared Tweet on that play? Nice pass break up there. And as we look at this replay here on our monitor, nice pass, but it looks like he can hold on to it right there, Paul, and Jared Tweet with a nice hit.
A little juggle there when he went up for it, couldn't quite come down with it, and Jared Tweet made sure he didn't come down with it. Give him a little shove in the back there.
Pistol formation for the Wildcats again. Here comes Ludlow. And man, he's a violent runner for the Wildcats so far. He's only got 1 carry on the game, but man, he's been effective so far.
Big shouldered running back there, 6'1", 215, Ryan Ludlow there. Drops his shoulders there, gets a few extra after some contact there.
Ludlow, 2 attempts, 13 yards. And Osborne back to pass again. Pressured by A.J. Page, almost knocked it down, but he will complete it to his guy number 14 for the Wildcats, Brian Kent. His 3rd reception on the game, and he'll get the first down. And so far, so good for the Wildcats. They convert on another 3rd down. 2 of 4 so far, 5:25 left in the 2nd quarter. Osborne looking short again, and he'll get his tight end there, number 88 for the Wildcats. Peyton Hogan, his first reception on the game. Sophomore out of Omaha, Nebraska. It'll be 2nd down And 5-4, the Wildcats on the SMSU 43. And it looks like a timeout for the Mustangs. So we're going to take a timeout as well, a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Southwest Minnesota State University, where private school atmosphere meets public school cost. Programs like culinology, agronomy, and environmental science set the standard nationwide, where grad placement rates are over 97%. And the school invests in you, putting over $80 million back into the university. Southwest Minnesota State University, where you belong.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. And again, it's looking pretty nice outside, Paul. You know, a clear night. Not really too chilly here tonight.
Yeah, definitely been blessed with some good weather here late into October here in Minnesota, especially Southwest Minnesota. About this time last year, we had about a half inch of snow on the ground. So hopefully that doesn't come relatively anytime soon.
Yeah, 76 yesterday. And a nice cool night for a game of football here on Saturday night, where the Mustangs trail the Wildcats 21-14. Wayne State, so far, rushing-wise, 54 yards, passing yards, 182. And here comes Osborne. He's got some pressure, but he'll hit it and give it to McDaniel. It looks like he bobbled it there, but he'll complete the catch at about the 36-yard line. McDaniel, his sixth reception of the game. 6 for 60 and touchdown. Mustangs are trying to keep him in check, but, I mean, this guy is quite good. I mean, with that 6'4 frame, he can just reel anything in.
Yeah, there's not really a good matchup defensively that you can go against McDaniel, honestly. Try to go Andrew McReynolds on him, doesn't seem to work. Try to go a linebacker on him, doesn't work either.
He's going to go deep, and it looks like McReynolds will pick it off. Interception by Andrew McReynolds. Looks like Osborne was looking for Kent there. We'll look at the replay. And great recognition of the route. Looks like Osborne was trying to, you know, have a jump ball right there, and McReynolds comes out with the interception.
McReynolds had the angle on it, read the ball the whole way right in, perfectly timed jump, and was able to bring it down.
And 2 weeks ago, Andrew McReynolds had a nice interception against Upper Iowa, and he gets one tonight here at home. The Mustang offense back out on the field. Scored a touchdown last drive. Hopefully they can tie it up here on this drive. Tyler Tonnerum on the carry. A short gain.
If you're SMSU, you want to move this ball the way you've been the first drive and the most recent drive. Get it quickly and keep that up tempo. Hopefully come out with points here to end the half.
Four wide set for the Mustangs. And he'll throw it. Nice slant route to Nathaniel Hewitt, and he'll break a couple tackles, and he'll get the first down, tackled at about the 29-yard line of the Mustangs. Nathaniel Hewitt, his fifth reception on the game. And that'll put him over 30 yards on the game. And Kern's going to hand off to Tonnerum, and he's got some running room, and he'll be tackled at about the 40-yard line of the Wildcats. Looks like you said, Paul, no huddle, up-tempo offense.
It's worked effectively for them in the past, and why not go to it right now?
And nice tackle by Tony Bobo on that play. Second and about 8 for the Mustangs on the SMSU 42-yard line. Kern's going to roll out to the right. He's looking for Hewitt, but he's got some pressure. But he'll stiff-arm a Wildcat, and he'll just run it there. And it looks like and it'll be a late hit out of bounds on the Wildcats.
Just a shower of flags right there for the late hit out of bounds.
Look at the replay here. Nice stiff-arm by Charlie Kern. Just going to run it out of bounds.
Had 1, maybe 2 feet out of bounds, and then got the shove there from the Wildcat defender.
Abram Walker, senior out of Omaha, Nebraska, with the penalty. That is the fifth penalty, or excuse me, the sixth penalty on the Wildcats, and the Mustangs have capitalized on almost all their penalties. It'll be handoff to Devontae Stevens, and he'll hurdle a defender, but he'll be tackled at about the 40-yard line. One-yard gain for the Mustangs on that play. Devontae Stevens, his fourth carry of the game. Four attempts, 25 yards. And it'll be handoff to Stevens again, and he'll bounce off a tackler, and he'll keep his legs moving. He'll be tackled about the 36-yard line. So looking at some of the rushing stats here, Paul, 127 rushing yards in this first half. You got to like what you're seeing from our rushing offense.
Definitely Tyler Tondrum, Devontae Stevens, even Charlie Kern, too, have made the rushing attack very effective here in the first half. Hopefully can build off that, too, into the second half as well.
2 minutes and 14 seconds left in the second quarter. And Devontae Stevens in the backfield with Kern. Kern's going to throw a quick screen to Stevens, and he'll be tackled about the 35-yard line. Good job by the Wildcats to contain Stevens on that play. That would be a fourth down for the Mustangs. They haven't attempted a fourth down yet because of the penalty on the Wildcats on that encroachment. So Kern trying to get him offsides again, but it won't work. And Coach Sauter will take a timeout here. And we'll take a timeout as well. We'll take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Cans, water bottles, and clothes. These forms of aid cost more to ship than you think. Cash donations provide immediate and effective relief to those who need it, without the shipping costs. If we all do our part, together, we can provide help across the world. To learn more, check out CIDI.org.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University. The Wayne State College Wildcats are leading the SMSU Mustangs 21-14, 1:29 left in this first half. And so, Paul, what are your thoughts on this first half so far for the Mustangs?
You know, both offenses have performed to the level that I was expecting. Wayne State performing at the level that I've seen all season from them. Southwest, you know, they've had a few moments, they've had a few hiccups along in this game so far. They've definitely shown the offensive style and capability that they know they can have.
Here comes four wide set trips to the right for the Mustangs. Kern's looking. A nice screen play to Tyler Tonnerum. He's got some room. One Wildcat to beat, and then he'll be diving into the end zone. Touchdown, Tyler Tonnerum. His second of the game. A nice pass by Charlie Kern. Nice screen pass. Looks like the Wildcats got caught off guard, and Tyler Tonnerum, he did the rest and got the touchdown.
Charlie Kern there had two Wildcat defenders in his face, was able to get the ball out to Tyler Tondrum, who had nothing but real estate right in front of him, and he cashed in big time.
And here comes the extra point. Olsen to Wank. The kick is up. The extra point is good. The Mustangs tied up 21-21. 1:19 left in this second quarter. And you're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
At 32, Carol had her first heart attack. Michelle began kidney dialysis right before graduation. A brain seizure kept Maria out of work for nearly a year. Without warning, lupus can attack the major organs. Every day, it disables its victims, especially women. Like most Americans, I didn't know how life-threatening lupus could be until my sister was diagnosed. It's time we do something about it.
For more information about lupus, contact the Lupus Foundation of America.
And welcome back. And Look at this Mustang drive here, Paul. 9 plays, 86 yards, took 3 minutes and 7 seconds off the clock. Mustangs tie it up. Charlie Kern, 30-yard touchdown pass, 35-yard touchdown pass, that is, to Tyler Tonderham. Tyler Tonderham, he can run the ball, and also he can catch the ball, and he can make some guys miss.
Yeah, you can definitely see that Tyler Tonderham looking like the player that he was last season on that drive. Big tackle right there.
Daryl Thomas on the tackle. One of the seniors that was honored today. It is senior night. 12 Mustang seniors were honored before the game with their families. They're trying to get a win here to improve to 3-5, and here comes Wildcats back out on the field. And if you're the Wildcats, Paul, do you try and get a quick score here? Or?
You know, they're definitely capable of it. Zach Osborne being able to connect with his receivers downfield. I personally feel that this is right where they want to be. Minute 13 with 3 timeouts. They definitely can get a score on the board here before the end of the half.
It looks like Osborne's going to run it here. Had some nice blocking, but he'll only get 3 yards on that play. It'll be 2nd down and 7 for the Wildcats. And Osborne is only 2nd attempt rushing. And he's been quite good passing the ball, 12 completions, 19 attempts, 189 yards, 2 touchdowns, and 1 interception. Here Osborne rolls out to the left. He's looking for his guy, number 14, Kent. He'll be tackled at about 30-yard line. And he'll be out of bounds. 1 minute left in the second quarter. First down for the Wildcats. And Osborne in the pistol formation again. 3 wide set. McDaniel on the right. Got to watch out for him. Osborne's going to throw a screen pass to Yates. And McReynolds with the nice tackle. It'll be 2nd down for the Wildcats. Andrew McReynolds, already an interception on this game, has had a couple tackles as well. Nice pass breakup earlier in the game.
Not gaining the big yards that they would expect in Wayne State, but they're definitely moving the ball effectively. 56 seconds left here in the first half.
Osborne rolling right, and he's looking. He'll throw it out of bounds. Almost looked like it would be a nice interception there for the Mustangs, but
they're just a little too high.
A little too high there, and it'll be 3rd down for the Wildcats. They have been 2-of-4 on 3rd down so far in this game. And looking at Wayne State, overall their 3rd down conversions, 44% on the season.
Big 3rd down right here, Matt. If they do hold him here on 3rd down, makes it a little interesting for Southwest to see what they can do with the time left.
And he'll throw it to McDaniel, but it looks like he led his receiver too much on that play. And the Mustangs will get the ball here, so it makes things a little bit interesting here, Paul. 45 seconds coming up here. So if you're Coach Sauter, I'm thinking you're guessing maybe try to get a quick score.
Definitely, with Andrew McReynolds back to take the punt, he definitely can get a decent return. And see what the offense can do with, I'd say, roughly about 35, 30 seconds left on the clock after this punt play here.
McReynolds will field the punt. And the punt is up. Nice punt, and McReynolds will call a fair catch, but it'll roll out of bounds at about the 20-yard line. So 36 seconds left on the clock. The Mustangs will have the ball. And again, it looks like the Mustangs will probably show a couple screen passes here, Paul, and maybe a quick quarterback draw or handoff to Tyler Tonderham. And hopefully the Mustangs can get within field goal range or maybe even a touchdown.
Yeah, if you're Charlie Kerr in this situation, you got to be smart with the ball. 36 seconds left. You definitely don't want to go too deep for the home run pass, but at the same time, make it manageable. to create a play for your squad.
Tondrum will get the ball. He'll be tackled about the 21-yard line. 23 seconds and counting. It looks like the Mustangs are going to run out. Well, maybe not. We'll see. Maybe there's a trick play they got going on here. And we'll just hand it off to Tyler Tondrum. And he's got some room, and he'll break a couple tackles and be hit out of bounds. At about the 31-yard line, 4 seconds left in the second quarter. And it'll be a first down for the Mustangs. Tyler Tondrum, almost over 100 yards in this game in the first 18 attempts, 95 yards, and a touchdown. And one reception for 35 yards and a touchdown for Tyler Tondrum, and they'll give it to him again. And he'll get a short gain, or no gain on for that instance. That'll be the end of the first half. The Mustangs are tied with the Wildcats 21-21. We'll be back with our halftime show going on. So we'll be back with 2 minutes before the game, before the second half. And you're watching Mustang football here on KSSU TV.
Your heart rate's a little fast.
Cause of death, acute myocardial infarction.
Have you tried a weight loss program?
Likely caused by type 2 diabetes and heart disease.
Still smoking?
Victim's lungs are black and scarred.
You can get a physical exam now, or you can get one later. Use our free risk calculator and talk to your doctor. Lower your risk for type 2 diabetes and heart disease and live a healthier life.
And welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center and on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University, and where the Wayne State College Wildcats are tied with the SMSU Mustangs 21-21. And let's take a look at some of the stats here for the Wildcats. Zach Osborne, 14 completions, 23 attempts, 198 yards, 2 touchdowns, and 1 interception. And looking at the rushing stats, Lane Yates, 9 attempts, 40 yards, and a touchdown. And Ryan Ludlow, 2 attempts, 13 yards. And Zach Osborne, 2 attempts, 4 yards. Receiving-wise, for the Wildcats, Cole McDaniel, 6 receptions, 60 yards, and a touchdown. Brian Kent, 4 receptions, 54 yards. And then you look at Lane Yates, 2 receptions, 5 yards. And Adam Stark, 1 reception, 74 yards, and a touchdown. And Peyton Hogan, 1 reception and 5 yards. So let's send it over to Paul Vold with the SMSU stats.
Charlie Curran, quarterback, is passing 17 of 23 for 128 yards with 2 touchdowns. Rushing stats are Tyler Tondrum has 19 carries for 96 yards with 1 touchdown. Devontae Stevens has 4 rushes for 26 yards. And Charlie Curran also has 4 rushes for 22 yards. Looking at the receiving stats as well, Nathaniel Hewitt leads the way with 5 catches for 39 yards. Jordan Cross has 3 receptions for 12 yards. Nate Carr has 24 yards on 2 catches. And Adam Olson has 9 yards on 2 receptions as well.
So kind of looking at some of the stats here, Paul, I mean, both teams are looking to get back on track after, you know, a couple of tough losses. So what are you looking for the Mustangs to do in the second half? Adjustments?
Looking at the stats from the first half, SMSU has possessed the ball longer than Wayne State, but Wayne State has also struck quicker than SMSU. So what I'm looking for them to adjust is possess the ball a little bit more than Wednesday, but be able to contain them offensively as well.
So that is your halftime report here. And the Mustangs going to kick it off to the Wildcats here. And the kick returners for the Wildcats, Tyree Bethea and Jonathan Parks. And the kick will go to Parks. He'll take it up to the 10, the 15. And Daryl Thomas is trying to chase him down. But a couple of Mustangs will take him down, but there looks like to be a flag on the play.
Could be a holding there. It looked like Tyler Flood there, number 16, Nathan Scott, were in the middle of that melee.
Looks like it will be on the Wildcats, and that'll back them up a little bit. They had six penalties in the first half, so the Wildcats definitely don't want that to happen here in the second half. And that'll back them up to about the 11-yard line. Mustang defense comes back out. And a couple of tough plays they had on a couple of drives, a 74-yard touchdown by Osborne to Stark. And, you know, there have been quick strikes, but it looks like the Mustang defense has played, like we'd say, about subpar.
They've had
and it's almost intercepted by Tyler Flood, and he is fuming on that. And, oh, man, that would have really helped the Mustangs there.
That would have been an easy strut to the end zone for Tyler Flood there to get six. He's kicking himself about that one. Read the route perfectly and just picked up the ball off Osborne.
And Osborne will hand it off to Yates, and he'll get a short gain on that one. I'm looking at the rushing. Total rushing for the Wildcats, only 57 yards from the Mustangs, doing a good job of keeping the Wildcats in check rushing-wise. And a third down and seven for the Wildcats. They have been 2 of 5 on third down. Mustangs looking for a stop here. And here comes Osborne. Now the pistol formation again. Blitz by the Mustangs. He's got some pressure. He's looking for McDaniel. He'll catch it and he'll get the first down at about the 27-yard line. And like we said, Paul, McDaniel, seventh reception of the game. He just getting a lot of separation from SMSU defenders and making some pretty nice catches. 7 of 73 and a touchdown.
Cole McDaniel, being 6'4", has longer arms and wingspan, so definitely can create some separation off defenders. Definitely worked in his advantage on that reception there for the first down.
Zach Osborne will hand it off to Yates again. Another short gain. Nice tackle by number 4, Alex Oliver. Lance Boozer on the tackle as well. Filling in for Jacob Lefso, who has been lost for the season for the Mustangs. Lance Boozer filling in pretty good for him. Pistol formation again. Hand off to Yates, and he's got some running room, but he'll be tackled by Andrew McReynolds. Another third down here for the Wildcats.
Yates on that play was able to hide behind his lineman because the lineman's about twice the size as Yates on that play, but was not able to get more than a couple yards on that gain.
And again, 63 yards total for the Wildcats so far in this game, rushing the ball. Shotgun formation, and the pistol formation as well. It'll be underthrown. That'll be nice third down stop for the Mustangs. They'll get the ball here. Definitely what the Mustangs needed. Mustangs did trail 21-7 at one point in this game, but now they will get the ball and try to get the lead here. So good stop by the Mustang defense, Paul.
Definitely a good stop right there. I thought we would have had it there on the first set of downs there, but was able to hold Wayne State there on that second set of downs.
Number 27, Colton Hoff, 6-foot freshman, going on the punt. Nice snap and a nice punt. And McReynolds won't take this one. It'll be down at the 40-yard line, so the Mustangs have some pretty good field position here. And the Mustang offense coming back out. And like we said, Charlie Kern has been quite efficient in this game. 17 completions on 23 attempts, 128 yards and two touchdowns. So Charlie Kern, I think with that up-tempo offense, he gets more in the rhythm pretty easily here, Paul.
Yeah, Charlie Kern in the rhythm is a dangerous man to face because there's just so many options he can go with. He could hand it off to his running backs. He could throw out the quick screen to his receivers, or he could just run it for the first down himself.
Nice handoff to Tyler Tondrum. And, short gain on that play, but Tyler Tondrum on the game. His 20th rush on the game for, 96 yards in the first half. It's good to see Tyler Tondrum off to a hot start and looking to improve in the second half as well. Kern getting the play from the sidelines. The shotgun formation again. He's looking short. Nice catch by Jordan Cross, and he'll get the first down, and he'll get it into Wildcat territory. Tackled at about the 41-yard line.
Jordan Cross there was in the slant and was able to get some separation off the defender and had at least a good 5-yard cushion around him.
Tyler Tondrum with a short gain on that play to the outside. And the Mustangs definitely going on a little bit of a drive here, getting in Wildcat territory. Second and 11 for the Mustangs. And Charlie Kern is going to go out of the pocket, and he'll be knocked out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. Charlie Kern, his fifth attempt on the game rushing the ball. We see a lot of his mobility day in and day out. Five attempts, 27 yards.
Couldn't find anything down the field, or if there was, he wasn't too confident in it, so he just decided to take the ball himself and try to get out of bounds to create something.
10:52 left in the third quarter. It'll be a delayed handoff to Tyler Tondrum. He'll get a short gain on that one. Pretty close to the first down.
About a yard and a half, two short.
It'll be fourth down. It'll be fourth and one. The Mustangs are 1 of 1 on fourth down in this game. Devontae Stevens into the game. They'll go to Stevens. And it looks like he will reach for the first down. Looks like he did get it. And they will call it a first down. Devontae Stevens, fifth attempt on the game, 28 yards. And a flag on the play here. The false start on the Mustangs. False start on Austin Hilgert, 6'3", 274 freshman.
Just got a little too excited on that play, try to get that up-tempo offense going again there for the Mustangs.
And here comes Kern out of the shotgun, 4-wide set. Kern trying to get the Wildcats offsides again. Worked a lot for him in the first half. Kern takes the snap. He looks like he's going to run, or he's going to throw it, and it's tipped, and it's caught by one of the Flo brothers, Jordan Cross. How about that play? Let's check out this instant replay.
Just an awkward toss there. He was caught whether or not he should run it, and he just kind of threw a grenade out there to Jordan Cross, and luckily he was able to wrangle that catch in after it went off the hand of a defender.
Kern's got some pressure, and he's trying to scramble around, and he'll make some nice moves, but he'll finally be taken down at about the 29-yard line. Charlie Curtin trying to make something out of nothing.
Definitely him scrambling around in the pocket and trying to gain extra yards there is keeping this drive alive here for the Mustangs.
Here comes Kern in the shotgun with Stevens. And looking at the Wildcat defense, looks like they're going to show blitz. Only two down linemen. Kern's looking. And he's got Hewitt, and he's got some room, and he'll break a couple tackles at about the 10-yard line. He'll be tackled at about the 5. So Nathaniel Hewitt, his 6th reception of the game.
You cannot get more wide open than Nathaniel Hewitt got on that play. No defenders around him. Curran throws an absolute strike right to him. No defender within 10 yards of him and was able to get it down inside the 5.
Handoff to Devontae Stevens. Looks like he broke a tackle there, but hit immediately at about the 3-yard line. Second and goal for the Mustangs. Trying to take the lead here in this third quarter. 8:02 left in the third quarter. Kern in the shotgun, trying to get Wildcats offsides again. Almost got him. Changing up the play here. Kern takes the snap, rolls right. Looking, and then, what a play. Nice play by Charlie Kern to fake out the defense, going to the right. And a nice throw to Nate Carr for the touchdown.
Had the defense sucked in, going to roll, with him rolling to his right there, throws it back to his left. Nate Carr wide open.
How about that? Nate Carr with his 3rd reception of the game, and he has 3 receptions, 28 yards, and that nice touchdown, 4-yard completion. And here comes the extra point, and it is up, and it is good. The Mustangs take a 28-21 lead over the Wildcats. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU Television.
What's it like when you hear your calling? Will you ignore it, or will you listen? What if it calls you to go halfway around the world? To serve people you've never met? What will you do when you hear your calling? Peace Corps, life is calling. How far will you go?
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center, where the SMSU Mustangs have taken the lead over the Wayne State College Wildcats, 28-21. And a nice 4-yard touchdown pass, Charlie Curran to Nate Carr. 11-play, 59-yard drive. Took 4:54 off the clock. Mustangs take the lead, and I got to say, you know, the Mustangs on the past couple drives have just been very efficient, and now they finally take the lead. And here comes Yates again, and he'll be nice hit by Daryl Thomas. Excuse me. I believe that was Jonathan Cross on the tackle.
Another good play there on special teams.
Yates is down on the field. Check out the replay, see what happened here.
He took a wallop of a hit, I know that for sure. He got crunched up, I believe.
And then he'll be on the ground there. It looks like something with his knee. So we're going to take another 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Ladies, are you talking to your partners
about HIV?
2 out of every 3 new HIV AIDS cases in women are among black women.
Get informed, get tested. Early detection can save your life. If you test positive, seek treatment from a doctor.
Join the campaign to end black AIDS, a partnership between Abbott and the Magic Johnson Foundation. Go to westandwithmagic.com, get resources, and become a member.
And join today, and thank you.
And welcome back. And we got the Wildcats, and looks like Yates got off the field under his own power. Always good to see. Here comes Osborne, and that pass is deflected by Leon Perry, one of the other seniors that was honored during the game. Nice knockdown by Leon Perry.
Be the first knockdown of the game. There have been a lot of close calls from Osborne in getting passes knocked down, that one being the first successful one.
Osborne going to go an option over to Ludlow, and Ludlow has got some speed there, and he'll get the first down. Nice run by Ryan Ludlow. His only third carry of the game. First and 10 for the Wildcats. Ludlow will be in the backfield with Osborne. Osborne will hand it off to Ludlow again. He'll run it up the middle to about the 41-yard line of the Wildcats. Nice tackle by Leon Perry. A lot of substitutions for the Mustangs. A.J. Page coming off the field. Haven't called his name much today. Pistol formation. Gonna change up the play here. Mustangs backing off their coverage. They'll give the ball to Ludlow, and he'll be tackled at about the 41-yard line. No gain on the play. Good job by the Mustangs. Third and 5. And looking at the third down efficiency for the Wildcats, 3 of 7 on third down. So the Mustang defense has been pretty stout on third down, Paul.
Yeah, they've definitely held this offense of Wayne State in check all night on third down.
Nice pass. There was really no Mustang defensive back there to cover number 4 there for the Wildcats, and they'll get the first down. Adam Stark, his second reception on the game. He had that 74-yard touchdown early in the first half.
Just kind of a weird play right there. A bit of a quick snap from Osborne, and nobody was there to cover up
Ludlow's
Stark.
Ludlow's got some room, and he'll be finally tackled at about the 28-yard line. So good blocking from the offensive line by Wayne State. Ludlow, 6 attempts, 50 yards so far in this game. 100 yards total for the Wildcats. Another handoff to Ludlow, and he's, I mean, he had almost one block away from scoring a touchdown. The Mustangs doing a good job of making sure he doesn't get there. And Ludlow, I got to say, man, he's probably one of those Jerome Bettis-type guys as a running back. I mean, this guy is tough to bring down.
Just a ground-and-pound machine here from Ryan Ludlow. Just a big-shouldered, low to the ground, drives his shoulder and gets yards.
And over the middle, and then number 14 will dive in the end zone. Touchdown, but there is a flag on the play.
Could be roughing the passer, I believe.
And Osborne limping a little bit after the play. Not very happy about that. So it'll be touchdown for the Wildcats. Number 14 for the Wildcats on the touchdown play. Brian Kent, his fifth reception, 74 yards and a touchdown. A 20-yard touchdown play. So the Mustangs defense couldn't stop the Wildcats there, Paul.
Yeah, definitely this quick strike offense again with Ryan Ludlow getting most of the carries on that drive was unable to solve the problem of Ludlow. And Osborne as well getting those quick strikes.
And the extra point is no good, so the Mustangs still have the lead, 28-27. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang football here on KSSU-TV.
When you donate goods in response to an international disaster, it's expensive.
They have to cross the sea, pass through customs, be inspected, sorted, then finally delivered.
And often they arrive too late to help, making your good intentions feel a little empty.
There is a better way. Cash donations are fast, simple, and allow professional relief workers to purchase supplies close at hand.
Cash is best. Learn more at CID.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. And the Wildcats, on an 8-play drive, 74 yards, only took 2 minutes and 36 seconds off the clock. But they do miss the extra point. The Mustangs lead 28-27. The touchdown play, Zach Osborne, 20-yard pass to Brian Kent. So the Mustang defense couldn't hold them there, but they do miss the extra point. So technically, the Mustangs still have the lead here. And again, the 15-yard penalty was assessed on the kickoff. So they move the ball up to the 50-yard line.
This will be fairly interesting to see any kind of positive return on this one.
We'll see how this kick goes. And then nice deep kick. And it'll just be going for a touchback. Looks like some of the Wildcat players were trying to see if McReynolds was going to pick it up and take it, but it'll be a touchback.
It looked like for a second he was getting in position, but then the way the ball rolled right at him, it just went out the back of the end zone. Lived to fight another day on that one.
Exactly. So here comes the Mustang offense. Their past two drives, they scored touchdowns. So Charlie Curtin looking at his stats. 21 completions, 27 attempts, 178 yards, and 3 touchdown passes. 1 to Nathaniel Hewitt, 1 to Nate Carr, and 1 to Tyler Tondrum. So Charlie Curtin has been quite efficient so far in this game.
He's definitely made the right decisions with the ball as well. Definitely one play might have been an interception, but the defender dropped it. But otherwise, he's made the right decisions when throwing the football.
Charlie Curran's going to run it here. He'll be tackled at about the 29-yard line of the Mustangs. So a nice little run by Charlie Curran there. His 7th attempt on the game. And it'll put him at about 33 yards rushing. 34 yards, excuse me. Curran will give it to Tyler Tondrum. He'll break a couple tackles, but he'll get nowhere on that play. Good job by the Wildcat defense. 4:13 left in this third quarter. Mustangs lead 28-27 this game. Tyler Tondrum, 23 attempts, 97 yards, and a touchdown.
It's like Tondrum will be in the slot here on this play.
And Tyler Tondrum has a reception for 35 yards and a touchdown, so watch out for him here on this play. And Curtin's going to run from the pocket, but he'll get out of there, and he will get the first down. Nice run by Charlie Curtin, and man, if there's nobody open downfield, Charlie Curtin will tuck it and run, Paul.
You know, the pocket collapsed right around him. He did a double turn right there. Spun once, spun twice, went to his right. Thought about throwing it, and then just the awareness to know where that first down marker is. And a very smart move right there by Charlie Curtin, and got the first down.
There, Tondrum, another short gain on that play. Wildcat defense so far has been doing a good job of containing Tondrum. Had 96 yards in the first half and still only has 96 yards. The Mustangs calling the play here. And here comes Adam Olson in motion. He's looking for Tommy Steidler with a short catch on that play. Short pass, short catch. Only about 1 yard there, so. Charlie Curtin doing a good job of analyzing the defense there, but only a short pass. 22 completions, 28 attempts, 179 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Curtin back to pass. He's going to look deep for Nathaniel Hewitt.
He's got to step on
the receiver, but it'll be knocked out. Irby with the nice coverage on that play. Almost looked like Nathaniel Hewitt was going to reel it in there as we look at the replay.
Irby was able to get a hand on just at the last second to jostle that ball away from Hewitt.
We've seen Nathaniel Hewitt make those catches against Upper Iowa. Of course, he had the nice touchdown play. Mike Wank will punt it here. And Wank had 3 punts in the first half, 144 yards, 48-yard average. And number six, Mathieu will take the catch, but he'll fall down, and he'll be down about the 21-yard line. Looks like the turf monster got him again.
Yeah, that one, that kick by Wank was a high knuckling ball. Not really much a returner can do on that, so it's just safe to go call for the fair catch.
And here comes the Wildcat offense, scored on their last drive, but missed the extra point. That could come back to haunt them there, Paul, too. Here comes Osborne, they're laying it off to Yates. And Yates back in the game. It'll be a 2-yard loss on the play. Nice tackle by Tyler Flood.
Definitely got off his block, off the line, and was able to stop Yates for a nice tackle for loss right there.
Pistol formation. Here comes Osborne, and he's going to throw it short. But he'll be down. Looks like his knee was down at about the 27-yard line. Hogan on the catch. Another third down here for the Mustang defense. The Wildcats, 4 of 8 on third down. 1:15 left in this third quarter. Here comes Osborne in the shotgun. Blitz here, and a quick pass to Yates. Nice catch by Yates.
Might be a little close on this one, depending on the spot. It's going to be fairly close.
And it looks like
it is very close.
Very
from our
close.
So I'm going to ask for a measurement here.
Measurement here, and looking at the replay, yes, it's quite close. They'll bring out the chains. First, it seemed like he did get it, but like you said, depending on the spot here, check this out.
It is extremely close. Wow.
The Wildcat offense is saying they should go for it. And it looks like the punt team will go. Well, you got to look out for a fake here. You never know.
Yeah, you never know in this situation, depending on the personnel they have on the field here. You could definitely watch for a fake.
Especially last Sunday in the NFL, the Seattle Seahawks and the St. Louis Rams.
You just never know when it's going to come out.
Wouldn't be surprised if the Mustangs make sure of that, but they will punt the ball. Nice punt. And McReynolds will field this one. He's dangerous here. And he'll break a tackle, and he's got some blocking, but he'll take it up to the 41-yard line of the Mustangs. Good field position. So here comes SMSU offense back out on the field. 27 seconds left in the third quarter. So, Paul, what do you like from the Mustang offense so far?
Yeah, so far they've definitely made a lot of right decisions. Charlie Kern, you know, 22 of 29 passing, 179 yards with 3 touchdowns. But he's also running quite a bit more. He's got 8 attempts for 41 yards. He's definitely making decisions. If there's nothing down the field, he's going to tuck and run, and he's definitely made a lot of good plays because of it. And he's also hitting a lot of receivers too. Looking at our stat sheet here, about 8 to 9 different receivers have caught a reception here tonight.
Nice run by Devontae Stevens. His 7th attempt on the game, and he'll get him over 30 yards. And like you said about Charlie Kern there, Paul, 8 attempts, 41 yards from scrambling from the pocket. Screen pass to Stephenson. And he'll get some yards, and he'll get a first down, and he'll be down at about the 35-yard line. So Ty Stephenson, his 3rd reception of the game, looking at this replay here. Nice blocking from the Mustang receivers.
Hewitt and Olson there. Beautiful blocking right there to allow Stephenson to get the first down.
And that'll be the end of the third quarter. We'll be back with 4th quarter action here on KSSU TV.
When I was first diagnosed with HIV, Cookie and I decided to fight this disease. Now we're here to urge you to stand with us in the fight against HIV.
In the U.S., about half of the new HIV cases have occurred among African Americans.
Get informed, get tested. Early detection can save your life. If you test positive, seek treatment from a doctor.
Go to WeStandWithMagic.com, get resources, and become a member today.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University, where the SMSU Mustangs lead the Wayne State College Wildcats 28-27. The Mustangs are driving here, Paul, and looks like the Mustangs can really extend that lead. What do the Mustang offense have to do to keep this Wildcat defense at bay here?
You know, they just need to keep going up-tempo is what they've been doing the last couple of drives here. Make that defense a lot more tired, see a lot more hands on the hips, and just creating havoc for the defense there with those quick screens and getting the ball to either Devontae Stevens or Tyler Tondrum.
Shanti Payne will be in the backfield this time. And trips to the left. We got Ty Stephenson, Nathaniel Hewitt, and Jordan Cross. And Payne will switch to the left in the backfield. And Kern will roll out to the left. And he's trying to avoid a bunch of what an interception by the Wildcats. And he'll take it to the house, and the Wildcats will take the lead 33-28. Charlie Kern was under pressure during that. As we look at this replay here, Paul, rolls out to the left.
Just tried to get away. Tried to get rid of the ball as well, but was hit on the throw, and it landed right in the arms of number 32, Zach Bierman.
Zach Bierman out of Battle Creek, Nebraska, 6'4", 195 junior. Great recognition to, you know, make sure to catch that ball, and he took it in for the touchdown. And a nice pick six, and Charlie Kern really probably should have taken the sack there.
Yeah, honestly, one of those times you just got to have to give in and just take one for the team on this one, and they're going to go for two on this to make it an even 7-point lead.
Trips to the right of the formation. Osborne switching up the play. Cole McDaniel to the left. Got to watch out for him. And he'll throw over the middle, and he'll find his guy, number two, Nick Roth, on the two-point conversion. So Wayne State College takes the lead 35-28. We're going to take a 30-second break here on KSSU TV.
Do you know a young woman with severe joint and chest pain, fever, skin rashes, and overwhelming fatigue? Common symptoms for a challenging ailment. Lupus. A very serious, sometimes deadly immune disorder. Lupus affects millions of people, usually attacking women during their childbearing years. Symptoms are often misdiagnosed for years. Delay in treatment can cost someone you love their family or their life. The Lupus Foundation of America wants to end this by educating physicians as well as those people at risk. Please help.
And welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. The Wayne State College Wildcats take the lead 35-28. A 53-yard interception return by Zach Bierman. And the Mustang offense, like we said, Paul, Charlie Kern probably should have taken the sack there.
Yeah, definitely. And he also, that being his first interception of the game, being the first turnover of the game, we brought that up in the pregame, winning the turnover battle. Therefore, the Mustangs are down.
And here we go. Mustang offense going to try to get back out here on the field. Hopefully get a good return here. And the ball will be out of bounds, so it will be flag on the play, and it will be moved up.
A break for the Mustangs on that one as that ball just rolled out of bounds about the 15-yard line. So good start there for the Mustangs.
So the Mustang offense had a rough, you know, again, 53-yard interception return, but they just got to kind of have short-term memory and forget about that and come back out here on this drive to tie this thing up. Ball will be at the 35-yard line of the Mustangs. 4:14:46 left in this fourth quarter. Charlie Kern. Looking short to Tyler Tonnerum. And he'll keep moving his legs up to the 41-yard line. Looked like it was about to be about a 2-yard gain, but Tyler Tonnerum made it about a 6-yard gain there.
Yeah, he tackled right away on that catch, but was still able to get about 4 or 5 yards on the carry there.
Tyler Tonnerum, his second reception on the game. And Kern's going to run quarterback draw here. He'll be tackled or tripped down to about the 46-yard line of the Mustangs, and he'll get the first down. It'll be another first down for the Mustangs, first and 10 from the SMSU 46. And you look at Charlie Kern rushing the ball, 9 attempts, 47 yards. 180 yards rushing for the Mustangs tonight. 199 passing yards for Charlie Kern. A quick pass to Nathaniel Hewitt. Nice screen play there. Tackle at about midfield, or the 49-yard line of the Wildcats. And here's that up-tempo offense you're talking about, Paul. And looks like they're trying to keep this Wildcat defense just making sure that they're on their toes. And here comes Kern, another designed run, and it looks like he'll get the first down, or pretty close to the first down.
A half yard short there on that one. But, yeah, definitely with the up-tempo style offense right here, keeping Wayne State on their toes is one thing, but then it opens up so many more options. If guys on defense are tired, you can go, you know, you could throw the ball out to one of the wide receivers. You can give it to Tyler Tonnerum, or just Charlie Kern can run it like he did on that last play.
Another screen play here to Adam Olson. And Olson will be knocked out of bounds at about the 41-yard line. And Adam Olson, one of the Flo brothers, his third reception on the game. Short gain on that play, and he has 3 receptions, 11 yards. 4 wide set for the Mustangs. Kern looking short to Nathaniel Hewitt. Perfect placement by Charlie Kern. It looked like Hewitt was covered pretty well, but Charlie Kern threw it low to Hewitt, and Hewitt was able to reel it in.
Just low enough for Hewitt to get under it as well, as he was sort of sliding. His momentum was sliding away from the ball. He was able to hold that in.
Tyler Tonnerum trying to get a couple yards there. About a 1 yard gain on that play. And it'll be no gain for Tyler Tonnerum. And Tyler Tonnerum still at 96 yards in the second half. At 96 yards in the first half, like we said. Charlie Kern changing up the play again. Give it to Tyler Tonnerum, and he'll get a couple more yards. A violent tackle by number 50 of the Wildcats. Tyson McGill, senior from North Polk, Nebraska, with the tackle. Third and four.
That gave Tonnerum a couple extra yards there as he gets 6 on the play there.
Third and four for the Mustangs. And Kern's going to slow things down a little bit as Nate Carr moves to the right tackle. Kern blitz from the Wildcats, and he'll throw it short to Jordan Cross, and he's got some room, and he'll be tackled at about the 9-8 yard line of the Wildcats. As we look at the replay here, Charlie Kern just got it off in time.
Cross there, gets his hands up. That ball was coming in real fast on him. He was just able to get his hands on it and get a really nice gain there, put them up inside the red zone here.
Jordan Cross, 18 yard. Charlie Kern to Jordan Cross, 18 yard gain on that play. Jordan Cross, 6 receptions, 50 yards. 10:37 left in this fourth quarter. The handoff to Devontae Stevens, but he won't get much. or Ashanti Payne, excuse me, on the carry. His first carry of the game. Second and goal for the Mustangs. In the first half, in the red zone, the Mustangs were 2 of 2. And it looks like they're trying to go 3 of 3 here in this fourth quarter. Curran going to change the play up again. Play clock is at 6 here. Curran's trying to get it off. And Coach Sauter will take a timeout. 9:52 left in the fourth quarter. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Does retirement have to wait until my 70s? Is it great college for our kids?
Out of the question.
Is the American dream
out of our reach?
Not if we can help it. We're the National Endowment for Financial Education, a nonprofit organization dedicated to helping people just like you get smart about their money. Log on to smartaboutmoney.org today and start taking control of your financial life.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University, where the Mustangs trail the Wayne State College Wildcats 35-28. Mustangs in the red zone here, Paul. What do they need to do to punch it in and tie this game up?
You know, they just need to keep control of what they've been doing. You know, not let that interception the last drive really affect them too much. They've held themselves in check, you know, kept the pace just the way they want it, especially on that last play right there. Definitely wanted to draw Wayne State offside but was unable to, so they just decided to take a timeout to make sure the play call is right and hopefully drive this in here for 6.
And 426 yards for the Mustangs for offense so far. 191 yards rushing, 235 yards passing. Charlie Curran's going to throw, but he'll be sacked on the play. The Wildcats get the first sack of the game for both teams. Looks like Charlie Curran was trying to throw a quick hit to Nathaniel Hewitt there, but it looks like he was covered, and pressure got to Curran on that one. Now it's on the 13-yard line of the Wildcats, third and goal. Curran's going to change it up here again. Curran back to pass. He's looking for Hewitt again.
Got
him. A catch by Nathaniel Hewitt. Touchdown, Mustangs.
Just a beautiful pass right there from Curran to Hewitt. Hewitt, the only one that was going to be able to catch this ball right here, back shoulder right at the pylon for the touchdown.
What a perfect placement by Charlie Curran. Back shoulder throw is lethal in any level of football, I'll tell you that much. And here comes Mike Wake on the extra point to tie this game up. And the extra point is up. And it is good. The Mustangs tie the game up. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU Television.
Southwest Minnesota State will get you where you want to go. We're a university of 3,600 students with over 45 majors to choose from. Small student-to-faculty ratios let your professors get to know you. And with a grad placement rate over 95%, your degree will help you get a job in your chosen field. Becoming involved is easy. And with over $150 million in improvements the last 10 years, our facilities are state-of-the-art. Southwest Minnesota State University, where you belong.
And welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center, where the SMSU Mustangs tie up the ball game 35-35. And we'll take a look at the drive here. 12 plays, 65 yards, 5:36 off the clock. Charlie Curran, 13-yard pass play, touchdown pass to Nathaniel Hewitt. And like we said, Paul, I mean, that back shoulder throw and catch is quite lethal in any level of football.
Especially when you have Nathaniel Hewitt trying to make the catch on that one. Him being a basketball player as well here at Southwest, definitely knows how to get separation off a defender and able to bring in the catch for that touchdown right there.
What a Nice tackle by C.J. Record. Backup safety to Jared Tweet. With a nice tackle on the special teams play. 9:03 left in the fourth quarter, and here comes the Wildcat offense. Been pretty efficient. Zach Osborne, 19 completions, 31 attempts, 256 yards, and 3 touchdowns, and only 1 interception. Osborne back to pass, has some pressure, and he'll complete it to his receiver, and he'll break a couple tackles, and he'll finally be tackled, and the ball is out, and they'll say he was down on the play. And the Wildcats catch a break there. A nice pitch and catch there. Let's take a look at the replay here, Paul.
Yeah, Osborne rolling out to his right there. His number one, Jonathan Parks, makes a catch. Calling him down on that one, but I'm not 100% sure if he was. But at this level of Division II football, there is no replay system in place for challenges, so they'll just have to go off the referee's word.
And Ludlow will be tackled at about the 49-yard line. 6-yard gain on that play. Second and 4 for the Wildcats in Mustang territory. Osborne will give it to Ludlow, and he'll move it up to about the 44-yard line, and looks like he has enough for the first down. And it looks like the Wildcats are slowly moving here on this drive. Got to look out for Cole McDaniel here. I mean, he's been a thorn in the Mustang side. 7 receptions, 73 yards, and a touchdown. And Brian Kent, 6 receptions, 94 yards, and a touchdown. So, Paul, they got to get some press coverage here.
Yeah, Cole McDaniel and Stark have just been nightmares for the SMSU defense. Almost intercepted right there by Donovan Woods right there.
Brian Kent on the wheel route, and like you said, Donovan Woods almost had the interception there. It's a flag on the play.
Just multiple penalties tonight from Wayne State here, as it is their 7th penalty for 58 yards.
And every time the Wildcats have really gotten a penalty, the Mustangs have capitalized, making some defensive stops and capitalizing on offense as well. So here you go, Osborne. He's looking deep here to McDaniel, and he'll make,
just a little too high on that throw.
McDaniel almost reeled that in. Too far out for him. Blake Pennock almost was on the coverage there. And here comes number 29 for the Mustangs, Andrico Roll, junior from Miami, Florida. And like we said, Enrico Roll was coming in on that blitz there. Had a nice hit on Osborne.
Osborne definitely saw the pressure coming off from his backside and just wanted to get that ball out. It's just a little too far out from his receiver to make the catch there right at the sticks.
Here we go. Third down for the Wildcats. They're 4 of 9 on third down in this game. Mustang fans getting into it here. Screaming defense. Mustang showing blitz. Osborne back to pass. He's going to look deep. And he's got a guy, but Tweet is right there. And he'll almost make the interception. A nice pass breakup by Jared Tweet. Even though he didn't get the interception, let's take a look at the replay.
Yeah, just Osborne throwing up a prayer. Hopefully somebody will come down with it on his side. As it just goes off the hand of Tweet originally, and it goes off both his hands again, and just was not able to bring that one in.
But the Mustangs get a nice stop here on third down. Mustang defense has been doing pretty darn well on third down. 4 of 10 for the Wildcats. Nice punt, and McReynolds will field it. And he'll be hit hard at about the 28-yard line out of bounds. So here comes the Mustang offense back out to the field, the chance to try and take the lead. So, Paul, what are you looking for here on this drive?
You know, definitely the way Charlie Kern's been playing tonight. I mean, he's 29 of 37, 248 yards with 4 touchdown passes and that 1 interception. Definitely been a good night here for Charlie Kern. Hopefully he can keep that going, hitting all sorts of different receivers and running the ball as well. He's been a dynamic weapon here this evening.
And you look at Nathaniel Hewitt, 9 receptions, 94 yards, and 2 touchdowns. I mean, Nathaniel Hewitt, these past couple weeks has emerged in this Mustang offense.
Definitely a big-time threat. He's big, long-legged, long-armed individual who can go out and get a pass and break tackles and get extra yards on it too.
Tyler Tondrum will get the carry. Nice gain there to about the 27-yard line. 6:54 left in the fourth quarter. Both offenses have been pretty darn good, Paul. 388 yards for the Wildcats and 437 yards for the Mustangs. So it's been pretty much an offensive game here.
They've definitely moved the ball when they've needed to, and defenses have come up with stops when they've needed to.
Here comes Charlie Kern. He'll pump fake, and then he'll run out of the pocket, try to pump fake again, but he'll be tackled at about the 30-yard line. Charlie Kern is 12th attempt on the game. A couple yards there, 48 yards for Charlie Kern, rushing-wise. Mustang offense on third down. They've been 9 of 16, not too bad. Charlie Kern changing up the play here from his coaches and backup quarterback Blake Gimble. And Kern will be sacked at about the 29-yard line. Good pressure from the Wildcats. And the Mustangs will punt here. There's a 3-and-out here for the Mustangs, so Mike Wank will come out for the punt. And number 2, punt returner on the play for the Wildcats will be Nick Roth. Wide receiver, 6 foot, 190 pounds, sophomore from Omaha, Nebraska. Wank with a nice punt there, about the 30-yard line. And it looks like Tweet's going to chase him down, knock him out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. So here comes the Mustang defense. Had a big stop last drive. So what do the Mustangs have to do here to get another stop ball?
Yeah, they definitely need to keep jamming these receivers like they've been doing, get physical right at the line, and stay with them throughout the play, breaking up passes from Osborne, as well as getting pressure to him. As of late, they've been getting a little more pressure on him, causing some early decisions from Zach Osborne.
Here comes Osborne, rolls out to the right, but he'll hand it off to Yates. And Yates doesn't get much there. Good job by the Mustang defense of keeping him contained. And Tyler Flood and McCoy Rodney on the tackle. Second and 12 for the Wildcats. Mustang fans are getting into it here. Close game, 35-35. And Yates looking for his guy number 14. It looks like there's a late flag there. And it looks like it'll be a late hit out of bounds by the Mustangs. Blake Pinnick was the Mustang that knocked him out of bounds.
Just Not a very smart play there by Blake Pennick as he was out of bounds and then gave him a little extra shove there, costing his team 15 yards.
That is the only fourth penalty on the Mustangs here tonight.
It could be a costly one.
Well, they had to switch up. Had to fix the play clock there. Short stoppage in play. Pistol formation again. Ball it. First and 10 on the SMSU 44-yard line. And handoff to Yates, and Yates has got some room. Breaks a couple tackles, and A.J. Page is right there to take him down. I haven't seen much of A.J. Page here so far, Paul, but, I mean, it's kind of tough because this Wildcat offensive line has only given up 2 sacks this whole year.
Yeah, definitely. A.J. Page being a sack guy himself, definitely not getting that as much pressure as he would want on Zach Osborne and Wayne State, but he's making a nice tackle right there.
Mustangs showing blitz. And Osborne looking deep, but finally he will be sacked by number 97, Nate Werner, on the play. We'll take a look at the replay here.
This pocket collapsed around him. He decided to go for the run, but Werner was right there to meet him and dropped him for a loss.
Pardon me, that was Alex Werner on the play. Nathan Werner, his brother. Both of them playing well in this game today.
Be a third and long here for Wayne State.
There you go, Osborne back to pass. He's looking deep, he's got pressure, but he's got McDaniel. He'll get the first down and more and break a couple tackles, and he'll be finally tackled at about the 9-yard line. Jared Tweet on the tackle, McDaniel getting open. And Leon Perry hurt on the play for the Mustangs. And McDaniel, 8 receptions, 112 yards, and a touchdown. I mean, this guy can play ball.
He is a definite good player for Wayne State. 6'4", 210, just been an absolute wrecking crew for Wayne State against Southwest here tonight. I mean, 112 yards and a touchdown tonight just made the defense pay on that one.
And McDaniel's not the only receiver that has gone over 100 yards. Brian Kent, 7 receptions, 100 yards, and a touchdown. Looks like I formation from the Wildcats. Here comes a nice handoff to Yates. He'll be down at about the 2-yard line. So, time of possession battle has been won by the Mustangs. 34 minutes and 21 seconds. And you look at Wayne State, 20 minutes, 30 seconds.
Wayne State doing everything to control this clock right now. Down to 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter here. They have the ball exactly right where they want it. If they score here, it'll be very little time for the Mustangs to respond.
Mustangs are trying to get a turnover or maybe hold them to 3 points to give the offense a chance. And the Wildcats will take a timeout. And we're going to take a 30-second break as well. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
Will I always be working weekends just to stay out of debt?
Is it a great college for our kids?
Out of the question?
Is the American dream
out of our reach?
Not if we can help it. We're the National Endowment for Financial Education, a nonprofit organization dedicated to helping people just like you get smart about their money. Log on to smartaboutmoney.org today and start taking control of your financial life.
And welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center here on the beautiful campus of SMSU. Very nice night, very cool night. Not too cold, but you got the Wayne State College Wildcats here on the 2-yard line of SMSU. Tie game, 1:45 left. So if you're Christian Gunther, defensive coordinator, what are you trying to do to stop this Wildcat offense?
Well, you almost have to expect the run down here in this end. I mean, Wayne State has been pretty decent on the run. But what they really need to do is really control the clock, and that's what Wayne State's been doing, controlling the clock here when they got the ball back with about 4.5 minutes left, just driving down the field here.
Here comes I formation. A lot of big guys out there trying to get this. And Ludlow will waltz into the end zone. And the Wildcats will take the lead. And Ludlow, his 10th carry of the game, goes for a touchdown. Look at this replay here. Looks like the offensive line of the Wildcats won their ball.
Yeah, definitely. They brought in the big package. It was actually number 37, Chad Cook, who scored the touchdown there. It was primarily a fullback bringing in the big beefy package to drive in for the end zone.
And on the extra point will be Tyler Lindsay. Missed an extra point tonight, but has been otherwise pretty good. Here's the snap. Kick is up, and it is good. So the Wildcats take a 42-35 lead, 1:41 left in the fourth quarter. We're going to take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang Football here on KSSU TV.
How far would you go to help someone? Would you go to the end of your driveway? Would you cross a street? Would you cross an ocean? Would you go if you could use your knowledge to teach someone? And in the process, maybe learn something yourself. Life is calling. How far will you go? Peace Corps.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. The Wildcats went on a 7-play drive, 63 yards, took 3 minutes and 28 seconds off the clock, and are leading this game 42-35. A 2-yard touchdown run by Chad Coach. Wasn't Ryan Ludlow on that touchdown play. So, Paul, the Mustangs got 1:41 left. Still a lot of time to try and tie this game up.
Definitely they have two timeouts in their favor. It all starts here with what kind of return they're going to get from Andrew McReynolds.
Here comes McReynolds. He's going to try to move it back the other way, and he's got some room, and he'll move it up to about the 32-yard line. So pretty good field position, or turn that you definitely would like. And 1:33 left in this fourth quarter, the Mustang offense comes back out on the field. And again, you got to like the Mustangs' chances. I mean, in this game, Paul, you're looking at 438 yards of total offensive yards, and 190 yards rushing and 248 yards passing. So you got to look at this and maybe, you know, hit up some of those screen plays, get out of bounds, and maybe go deep.
Yeah, especially with the way the offense has been going up tempo in the second half of this game, they're definitely going to be interesting for this drive here. See if they can create something.
Charlie Kern back to pass. He's looking for Jordan Cross, one of the Flo brothers, and he'll break a couple tackles. Get the first down about the 44 and a half yard line. 1:23 and counting left in the game. The Mustangs trying to tie this game up. Charlie Kern back to pass. He's looking short. He sidesteps a defender, and he'll run it. And
he'll get out of bounds.
Get out of bounds and maybe even get the first down, maybe a little short. Down at the 48-yard line of the Wildcats. Stop the clock at 1:08.
So they're definitely moving the ball here. They're making it interesting. Minute 8 left here, just on the other side of the 50. They're definitely making some noise here.
Guy to watch on this drive is definitely Nathaniel Hewitt. A short pass to Tyler Tonderum, and he'll get a couple yards to about the 40-yard line. So the Mustangs are moving the ball on. The clock is going.
Go with it.
59 seconds and counting for the Mustangs, and we'll get the snap off. And it'll be a catch by Adam Olson, or excuse me, Jordan Cross. It'll go out of bounds. Short gain on that play. 52 seconds. Second and six for the Mustangs on the Wildcat 36. Mustangs trying to tie this game up. Charlie Kern has been very good in this game. 32 completions, 40 yards, 271 yards. Four touchdowns as well. Two to Nathaniel Hewitt, one to Tyler Tonnerum and Nate Carr. It looks like there'll be a timeout for the Mustangs. So we'll take a 30-second break. You're watching Mustang football here on KSSU TV.
They say America's the land of opportunity. But today, one out of every six children lives without enough. That's nearly 13 million of us living below the poverty line, struggling every day just to hang on. This is America. Together, we can do so much. Will you help? Go to povertyusa.org today and get involved.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center. So the Wayne State College Wildcats lead 42-35 over the SMSU Mustangs. 45 seconds left in the fourth quarter. The Mustangs have the ball at the Wildcat 35. So, Paul, if you're Coach Sauter, what are you thinking here?
Yeah, you definitely need to get the first down on this play and get out of bounds, too. You still have one timeout, 45 seconds.
Enough time for the Mustangs to get down in the end zone here. Charlie Kern will take the snap. Looking short, and it'll be caught by Adam Olson. He'll break a couple tackles. He'll be down at about the 25-yard line. And the Mustangs will hurry it up here.
That was one of the slowest-looking passes I've seen tonight. That ball just felt like it hung up there forever. And luckily, Olson was able to come down with it.
Kern, he's looking deep, and he'll be batted down. Bierman with a nice knockdown. He had the 53-yard interception return for a touchdown. 22 seconds left in this fourth quarter. The Mustangs trying to get the win here, or excuse me, to tie the game up on senior night. Here comes Charlie Kern in the shotgun. Kern takes the snap. He's going to run. He's looking for somebody, and he'll just throw it away. 15 seconds left. Good pressure there from the Wildcats. So it will be third down and 10 for the Mustangs on the Wildcat 26-yard line. Charlie Kern looking at some of his stats, 33 completions on 43 attempts, 280 yards and four touchdowns, only one interception.
This play here, you got to get the first down with it being third and 10.
Kern, he's looking left, but he'll throw it right in the middle to Nathaniel Hewitt, and he'll get the first down. There's 8 seconds left on the clock, and the Mustangs will hurry it up. Looks like the Mustangs are just going to spike the ball here. 5 seconds left on the clock. And I don't know if you'll get two plays here, but it seems like it might be the last play of the game.
This is definitely a one-play shot right here with 5 seconds left, barring a defensive penalty here. So you got to go the end zone here regardless.
Nathaniel Hewitt with 10 receptions on the game, 110 yards, and two touchdowns. Like we said, you gotta watch out for him. You gotta watch out for Jordan Cross, even Tyler Tunderham. It all comes down to this. Charlie Kern in the shotgun, takes the snap, play action. He's looking to slant, and it is caught by Jordan Cross. Touchdown, the Mustangs! Score! Oh my goodness. We'll take a look at the replay here. Charlie Kern throws a dart to Jordan Cross for the touchdown.
Just able to get a hold of that under the defender's arms.
The Mustangs are trying to tie this game up and go to overtime here. 42-41. Mike Wenk going to try and tie this game up. Low snap, but the kick is up, and it is good. So the Mustangs tie it up 42-42 on a nice catch by Jordan Cross. We're going to take a 30-second break, and then we'll be back with overtime action here on KSSU TV.
Alone, our reach is limited. No matter how great our intentions, on our own, we can only stretch so far. But at Rotary, we believe the right group of people working together can make our communities, our world, a better place. Rotary, humanity in motion.
And welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University. The Mustangs go on an 11-play, 68-yard drive. Took 1 minute and 33 seconds off the clock. Charlie Kern, 10-yard touchdown pass to Jordan Cross. The Mustangs are in OT here, the first time in OT this season. So, Paul, I mean, last play of the game, the Mustangs tie it up. I mean, they've got the momentum here going into overtime.
They definitely do. The way they've been playing offense this later in the first half into the second half with that up-tempo style has definitely worked out here, putting points on the board and getting that game-tying score to send it to overtime.
Like you said, the up-tempo offense for the Mustangs has just kept the Wildcats on their toes. And I got to say, Charlie Kern has been just doing great here. I mean, 35 completions, 45 attempts, 306 yards, 5 touchdown passes, only 1 interception. And you look at some of the receiving stats here too, Paul. Nathaniel Hewitt, 10 receptions, 110 yards. Had a big catch on that drive, on that last drive. 2 touchdowns. Jordan Cross, 9 receptions, 75 yards. Had the game-tying touchdown. And you look at Tyler Tonnerum, 3 catches, 48 yards on that nice screenplay for the touchdown. And then you look at Nate Carr, 3 receptions, 28 yards, and a touchdown. So, first time in OT this season for the Mustangs, and Wayne State, I believe, has been in OT as well this season. We'll take a look at that here for you. Doesn't look like it in this game, but they've come close in some games, like last week against Augustana, losing 52-48. So the Mustangs are in a close one here. Both teams have played pretty darn well. It's been an offensive game. Both defenses have stepped up as well. A couple of interception returns for touchdowns. And here comes the team captains out for another coin toss here in overtime.
If you're the team that wins the toss, you almost want to go on defense. That way you know what you have to do. If the team scores a touchdown or a field goal, you definitely need to do the same or better.
Listen in to see you. And the Wildcats, like you said, Paul, they're going on defense. Something you want, right? And Mustangs will start off with the ball. First and 10 at about the 35-yard line. And the Mustangs start off with the ball on offense.
Driving away from us, too, so yep. It's going to be a little more interesting on the angles and stuff, which they would have picked towards the open end of the stadium, so that way we could get a better view of what's happening.
Again, looking at the Mustang offense, 506 yards, total yards for the Mustangs, 200 rushing, 306 through the air. And then you look at the Wildcats, 115 yards rushing, 321 passing yards, 436 total yards. Both offenses have been playing at a high level. You look at Zach Osborne, 22 completions, 37 attempts, 321 yards, 3 touchdowns, and only 1 interception. Here comes Charlie Kern, and he'll give it to Tyler Tonnerum, and he's got some room, and he'll be tackled at about the 17-yard line. The ball was set at the 25, not the 35.
A little misdirection on that play. Charlie Kern going to his left, or going to his right, with Tyler Tondrum going to his left, so causing the defense to shift one way, getting multiple yards on that.
And the handoff to Tyler Tondrum, and he's got some pretty good blocking up, and he'll get the first down. So the Mustangs get a first down here. So far, so good for the Mustang offense. Tyler Tondrum reaching almost 30 carries on the game. It's been quite efficient here for the Mustangs. 29 attempts, 119 yards, and a touchdown. And here we go. Charlie Curran's going to throw it. Fade route, and it'll be knocked out. And Irby with a nice knockdown for the Wildcats. Irby looks like he's a little shaken up on that play. We look at the replay. Looks like Olsen almost could have reeled it in, but a good play by Irby. A couple of pass deflections here in this game for the Wildcats. And Irby will get up, limping a little bit, but he's going off on his own power. Always good to see.
Smart decision there by Charlie Curran to go for a shot at the end zone on first down, just to see if they could do something with it, but now he can set up the pass, setting up the run there. Hopefully they can get a big gainer closer to the end zone and punch it in here for 6 points.
And it'll be second and 10 for the Mustangs on the Wayne State 12. Trips to the right for the Mustangs. Curran gonna change the play a little bit, try to get the Wildcats offsides. Tyler Tondrum to his right. And Curran will take the snap. He'll go back to pass. He'll scramble. He's got a wide open man, but he won't go to him, but he'll run out to the 4-yard line. And it looks like the Mustangs had a shot to get the touchdown there, but Charlie Curran didn't see him. Let's take a look at this replay.
Had two receivers, I believe, in the back of the end zone towards the goalpost, wide open, and Curran just decided to tuck it and run. Just going out at the 5-yard line here. Still can get a first down.
Third and 3 on the Wildcat 5-yard line. 10 seconds left on the play clock. And here we go. Charlie Curran takes a snap, rolls out right. He's looking for his tight end, but he'll hold on to the ball and he'll be sacked. His helmet comes off. And Charlie Curran's trying to plead his case to the referee. And Curran still trying to plead his case here. And it looks like the Mustangs are going to take the 3 here. Pretty smart idea there, Paul. Take the 3 here.
I would definitely say take the 3 here with Mike Wang kicking.
Here we go, Mike Wank on the field goal. It's 4th and 8. Here comes Mike Wank. 39-yard field goal attempt. And the kick is up, and it is good. So the Mustangs will take a 45-42 lead. So we'll just keep it right here, since the ball will be at the 25-yard line of the Mustangs now. So, Paul, pretty good drive. Got the 3 points. Now the Mustangs just got to make sure they don't score a touchdown here.
Yeah, they definitely need to watch out for those big receivers so that Zach Osborne doesn't have a chance to get the 6 points, such as Adam Stark, you know, Jonathan Parks, Cole McDaniel.
Looking at Cole McDaniel, 8 receptions, 112 yards and a touchdown. And Brian Kent, 7 receptions, 100 yards and a touchdown. You got to look out for them. And Adam Stark, 2 receptions, 88 yards and a touchdown. So those are 3 guys to really look out for in this passing game. Here comes Osborne in the pistol formation again. Mustang fans chanting defense. And on a nice crossing pattern by Brian Kent, they'll be down at about the 10-yard line of the Mustangs. And here comes the defense, or Here comes the offense here for the Wildcats. They're hurrying up. Ludlow in the backfield with. Ludlow will get the carry. And he's bounced left, and he goes right, and he tries to get into the end zone, and he will score, and it is a touchdown for the Wildcats, and that will be the game. The Wildcats, the Wayne State College Wildcats, will win 48-45 here at Mackey Field. So we're going to take a 30-second break, and we'll be back with your post-game report here on KSSU-TV.
You can eradicate polio. You can promote peace. You can feed the hungry. You can help children do better in school. Because you can get involved with Rotary. Because Rotary believes that by working together, you can do anything. Learn more at Rotary.org.
Welcome back to Mackey Field here at the Schwann Regional Event Center on the campus of Southwest Minnesota State University. The Wayne State College Wildcats defeat the SMSU Mustangs 48-45. So we kind of look at this game, Paul, and the Mustangs did have their chance to win this game, but they just couldn't get it done tonight.
Yeah, definitely at the end there in overtime as well. Charlie Kern making the decision to run the ball when he had a couple receivers open in the back of the end zone. But at the time, it seemed like a smart, safe play. You know, you got the 3 points, but the defense wasn't able to hold up and get the stop as Wayne State was able to score six.
So we kind of look at some of the top guys in stats. So we look at Charlie Curran, 35 completions, 46 attempts, 306 yards, 5 touchdowns, and only 1 interception. Zach Osborne, 23 completions, 38 yards, 1 interception, 336 yards, and 3 touchdowns. And you look at some of the rushing stats here. Ryan Ludlow gets the game-winning touchdown. 10 attempts, 74 yards, and a touchdown. Lane Yates, 16 attempts, 51 yards, and a touchdown. And then you look at receiving-wise, 8 receptions for Brian Kent, 115 yards, and a touchdown. And Cole McDaniel, 8 receptions, 112 yards, and a touchdown. Mustang rushing was pretty good tonight, 29 attempts, 119 yards, and a touchdown. And Nathaniel Hewitt, receiving-wise, 10 receptions, 110 yards, 2 touchdowns. Jordan Cross, one of the Flo brothers, 9 receptions, 78 yards, and a touchdown. So the Mustangs fall to 2-6 overall, and the Wayne State College Wildcats move to 5-3. And the next home game for the Mustangs will be next week, SMSU versus Concordia St. Paul, and we'll be on the broadcast for that game. And then for the Wildcats, they will be playing at Upper Iowa at 6 p.m. So it's, again, a tough loss for the Mustangs, but Mustangs have to come back and play Concordia St. Paul next week at 1 p.m. and try to get it done, Paul.
Yeah, definitely. They got to look ahead to next week, you know, coming off this loss on senior night as well. Definitely a heartbreaking loss for the seniors on this team. But you have to look forward to what Concordia St. Paul is bringing here next week, a 1 p.m. kickoff. So that'll be interesting to play under the sun compared to all the night games that we have done so far this season.
And we thank you for listening tonight and watching, and good job tonight, Paul. And thank you to all the people in the back and all the people on the cameras doing a great job making us sound good and look good. And we'll see you next week when SMSU takes on Concordia St. Paul. And have a good night and drive safe.